Good evening, everybody. We're doing episode 4 of Outfit Showcase tonight. This time it is with Space Pigs, or Pigs on Connery. And this is the faction this time we're going to be playing with is the Terror Republic. So here we go. Let's switch over our views now.
That's for Bravo.
Okay, folks, Pale, we are live right now, as you can see. Yeah, as you can see right now, we are playing with Space Pigs tonight. So, Pale Tiger is the platoon leader, or the leader of the outfit. And looks like we got 1, 2, 3, 4 galaxies and one Valkyrie in the mix here. So, again, Space Pigs, say hi to the internet. You're all live.
I am with it.
Say hi to the world. You're all live right now. Say hi.
Hello, primitive version of us.
How you going? What's up? Welcome to the wider
internet. All right. So Pale, let's start things off. What are we going to be doing today? Take it away.
Right, we're doing gal drops. We're doing black ops gal drops, and that will most probably take a crack at.
Look at that, Valkyrie screwing up.
One pointer that's concealed, thinking about actually trying to save Hunter's blind, right, and get that back and push on to outpost and then put to Gurney Yam. We're just at the moment trying to finish this alert, but we've been double teamed for the last hour, right, so there's not much we can do about that. It is what it is. All right, everybody, mount up now.
Here we go. Here we go, let's do this. And hi Hash, how you doing? We're playing with Space Pigs tonight. So I hope you guys are going to have an interesting show tonight.
Okay, these are the situations.
The audio should be loud enough here.
Blind.
I got my audio set up like this.
Where I'll put the position.
Yep, everything's okay here. Master receive volume, transmit volume, everything's okay.
Let's go. You've got your waypoints set on your maps.
Here we go.
All your mini maps should be on H. Come on.
Everyone's taking off here shortly. Let's do this.
And Alpha, come on. Now slow down there just because. Let these two other galaxies catch up.
Here we go. We are going to be going off into an adventure here.
All right, go now.
And we are heading off to Hunter's Blind. We've about 20 seconds to go. Can they save it?
Escape or M is for the maps, so you give you an
idea. Here we go.
We must be losers as we jump in, but it is what
we got multiple gals going into position. Let's head on over to Hunter's Blind.
Too high, amazing sweet, that's greenhorn stuff. Here we go, drop.
Now I just need to get on the point, even though we lost it.
Right.
He touched the point, here we go.
Sneak back in and get to the A point.
Is there anybody here?
Oh, it's upstairs.
Well, I'm the only one upstairs. Oh boy. Oh, I was the only one upstairs. So let's go check out how these guys are doing. So let's spawn at the Sunder and check out how these guys play. This time we're going to be using Observer Cam to our advantage. Let's do this. Here we go. Let's do this. Here we go. Let's. There we go. Let's go check this out. First time for me using the observer camera. Let's do this. Here we go.
We outpop them, but what's happened? There used to be a jump pad here. Are you kidding me?
Oh yeah, they're trying to figure out where to go. The A building is right there, and it looks like they're struggling to make their way.
Go this way, then. They've actually changed that. Jump pad. Now that there's no jump pad.
Now they're trying to get. Now look at that, guys. They're trying to make their way to the point, but so far they're struggling to get there. Nothing up in the trees. Pigs are trying to make their way through. They're trying to go through the catwalk. There's Pale Tiger and his crew. They're trying to take this platform. That's going to take them all the way up.
Doing good. Until I get up there, the waypoints will have to stay the same.
Here they go. They're trying to fight through this hallway.
Is anybody behind us? No.
No, so far I'm not seeing anything.
Bravo squad.
Alpha's 4 is making their way through to the A point. They are contested. If I'm not mistaken, they are being backcapped. They are being backcapped at construction site Sigma.
On the back base behind us, and Sky Shield do a drop.
They're getting backcapped at construction site Sigma. Let's go check that out quickly.
On that point. You have a look at your map?
Let's see what's going on here at construction site Sigma. Yep. Ooh, it's no ghost cap. There's plenty of NC here guarding the point. Oh, they're doing a steel rain. Let's do this. They're doing a steel rain. Pale, you doing steel rain?
Yeah, I'm not doing it. Bravo is. I've given that to him.
All right, cool. We get to witness our first steel rain. This time, we're going to be witnessing it from the observer camera view. Here we go. Steel rain. That's one beacon down. That was one beacon. Here comes the rest of the crew. I see their names pop up.
Secure the perimeter.
Here they go. Doesn't look like all of them came at the same. Here we go. Look at that. Look at all those beacons come down. There's a bit of a delay before that beacon where those beacons showed up, but look at that. Here we go. Look at this, guys. TR is trying to get in there, but so far they're struggling. Yeah. It's no ghost cap. There's plenty of NC guarding this room. NC all over this room. Yeah, there is a decent amount of NC guarding every single room.
They're stopping 3 times the amount of people going in. So I can see us actually.
Don't worry, folks. We'll be joining the ground with them. I'm just giving you guys a perspective of what's going on here. Pigs is trying to get in there, but oh, they're getting close though.
What we'll do next, guys?
They're getting close to getting back onto the point.
Everybody hit the U button. Redeploy, redeploy, redeploy.
Okay, well, looks like we're leaving. Course.
Now, hit that U button, guys.
It's too late for Sigma.
Right, Bravo. You're not gonna get in there, are you?
Nope. It was a nice try with this mosquito pilot. Very nice flying by Astai, Ancient Tyrian. Oh, they're touching the point again. Oh, they're touching the point again. Awesome. They beat it last minute save at 27 seconds ago. Awesome. Construction Site Sigma is being recaptured. Now you just need to go back to Hunter's Blind after 3 minutes, even though we got 30 minutes to go.
If you're gonna talk to your squads, like Cowboy, what are you saying?
Cut off at Karen.
Cut off at.
It is. Everybody back to warp gate now.
Okay, time to redeploy. We're gonna be joining with Pigs now. Let's do it.
So the rest of us can actually go back to warp gate. We'll do the gal drops again.
There we go. Let's do it. Let's go join the gals.
Now the reason why we go back, for you guys that don't realize it, for the reason why we go to warp gate.
Now, hopefully the audio levels are coming okay this time. I got them boosted up as much as I can.
To look after this, right? So another outfit can take Hunter's Blind.
Let's get in.
Right, but we're gonna do what Cowboy said. So everybody's going to warp gate. Everybody redeployed back to warp gate. Right, someone grab a Charlie Growl, someone grab a Bravo Growl, an Alpha.
Here we go, let's go into the air once again.
Mark is down, we should just jump straight in. But I'll do it just for old time's sake. Bang, markers, Alpha, that Alpha one there, Alpha.
Oh, well, I've almost got a full Growl.
Alright. But that, Alpha, stay where you are, land it and stop jumping in. Right, Bravo. That's there. Now, the reason why we always go back to gate is, guess what? 99% of the time, it's the closest space anyway. Oh, you may not realize it, but it is. But everybody can directly redeploy there no matter what. And everything's available. All right?
Look at this mosquito just levitating on top of this gal. Pretty adorable, isn't it? Let's jump in again.
Cowboy, get into the trailer.
Let's get in.
Oh.
Alright, now we are gonna be heading over to construction site.
I'm serious.
Either it's gonna be Hunter's Blonde or Sigma. Oh, we're doing current station.
We got everybody on board. Alright, let's go. Let's go.
Let's do it.
We're not gonna get any more than this at the moment. People can redeploy back into the galaxy.
Let's go and kick some ass. Current station, 1,706 meters away.
I had to pick Rick. He deliberately went out of his way to cause trouble at the warp gate.
Ooh, check it. Deck this out.
We're gonna hit that A point, guys. Right? We're gonna hit that.
I believe this is a battle gal. Nice guns. Passenger kill. Awesome.
And we're gonna storm it.
Here we go. A huge Zerg. And we're gonna help it out. This should be exciting, folks.
Don't forget to come in. Keep going in, keep going, don't slow down, don't just stop.
Ooh, that was a rough landing.
Keep following down.
Ooh, that was a rough landing. Hit a 3 when we're trying to get in there. Nevertheless, it's a 9SX plus fight here at current station. Construction site Sigma is being back capped, but with Hunter's Blind, they're gonna be cut off. Look at how many Sunders are in this base. How many can you count on screen? 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. 11 Sunders. Okay, let's join the boots on the ground. No observer camera this time. Let's join the action like if you were one of them. I'm feeling a little bit of a slowdown here. All these people.
Oh, no.
Orbital strike. Get indoors. Get indoors. Hug a corner. There we go. Survive just like that. Let's go up these stairs. Oh, they're coming from that spawn room.
Push around, push around. What the hell?
Ow, I think a grenade just got me. They're basically flooding grenades all over those stairs. But we're still getting it though.
Control the A point. Do you know the way to go under the bridge?
It's basically spawn camping at this point. Ow. Okay, I'm getting revived over and over again. That's alright. Let's switch positions. The spawn room is just above these stairs.
Everybody press tab when you get a chance.
Here they come from that spawn room. That's another orbital. Look at that, another orbital.
And it's allowed. The deb's
actually... Minute to go, but the TR is still going to win this base with Hugh Zerg.
In this game, which is pretty
bad. Oh, Pale Tiger is down with his max, but we're still kicking ass.
Recursion, they're on all three. Empires. NC. VS.
Here we go.
Hard mode. That's why they don't ever play TR. Because the KD gets slaughtered.
Ow. Okay, let's just get back into the action, folks. It's just a spawn cap at this point.
Looks like cutoff worked.
We're kicking there. Hey, pretty brave of him just going in front of the spawn room like that. Hope the audio is coming in okay for you folks out there. Just having some good fun with Space Pigs tonight.
I am impressed.
Oh, we're doing good so far. Just another 10 seconds and this base is TR's. Who's gonna get the dominant outfit this time? Who's gonna take it?
Yeah, looks like the cleanup crew is picking up the stuff behind us.
And it's Drunk Division, HMRD this time. Hammer got it this time. And just like that, I became BR3. You know, I'm gonna spend some certs, mostly as combat medic. That's the one that I'm gonna be doing the most. Medic applicator is the most important. And then an armor kit is the next big thing we're going to be doing.
Yep, yep. We're still at 23 minutes. I mean, we seriously got double teamed about an hour ago.
Right, we really badly. VSR, Genesis, Eastern, Sub, and then Ziggurat. They're small, they're not giant three-pointers, and they would cause a cutoff.
On VR, right.
Yeah, looking at the situation here, VS still got the huge lead on Pop. And the territory control. And we're redeploying once more.
For anybody listening, that's the way we've been doing it for how many years, Tiger?
Forever.
Yep, and we're going to be switching to the observer camera view this time, just to witness how they're going to be flying this time.
Depends on the map that we're on, and for this, getting armor around very too hard.
I'm letting the outfit speak so you get to hear what they're talking about.
Everybody back to warp gate.
Bessemer used to be a good armor map until they turned it into whatever it is now.
Yeah.
Okay, let's switch to observer view now. Let's check out what Pigs is going to be doing next.
I'm starting to get that thing where I can't.
Here we go. We're doing another Gal transport in Space Pig style. Here we go. Everybody's hopping aboard the Gal.
There you go. Extended.
Cowboy into Charlie.
Everybody got a galaxy. That's Charlie Galaxy.
So far we got one Gal.
Bravo's been pulled. Has someone got Alpha Galaxy? Where is Alpha Galaxy?
So far.
No, did I tell you to be? You're supposed to be at your right. You're supposed to be at. Yeah, we'll come.
Here comes the second Gal.
Okay. When I say every single guy, we need to work, be on the same page with this, right? But yeah, if I say back to warp gate, I don't care. Fly the galaxy back to warp gate, but don't wait around picking people up. Everybody can get back here. So.
Here we go.
We have rules, and the rules are reasons that we abide by. That way it gives us better coordination. Remember, you guys. Remember we won the gold outfit wars? This is how we trained for it. Alright, we did that for weeks. Alright. We're gonna hit. I think that's the one.
Check out this awesome shot. All of them together, just like that. Oh, check out this awesome shot of all of them together, lined up just like that.
Let's go. Let's go. Is that galaxy back? Yep, good. That's all go now. Have you got their points to go to?
Let's go. Let's go follow them.
Roger that. That's the first thing we've got to do.
Alright, let's watch them all roll cinematic style. Here we go. We're going to war, everybody. Gonna love this cinematic shot. Imagine if there were a lot of Valkyries in the air. And if you're just tuning in, we're basically doing episode 4 of Outfit Showcase tonight. Tonight we're doing Space Pigs. Space Pigs is an outfit in Emerald. No, not Emerald. They're doing Connery.
You only become a target and it slows you down.
We got at least 3 Gals and 1 Valkyrie. This is Space Pigs, everybody.
They're...
Check out this battle. One mosquito. That site is not gonna have a chance. There goes that site. Here we go. Let's go into battle. Here we go. Charlie Squad Gal is down, but they got their troops on point. Dropped on the roof. Now they're trying to breach. Here we go. Let's breach inside. Let's see what's going on there.
Bravo had to deploy early, otherwise we get shot out of the sky.
Here we go. They're inside. Let's go check out what's going on here. Here we go. VS is responding. Oh no, that was Charlie's. That's Charlie's squad. My bad. Checked out the map. This is the situation right now on the map. We're currently at Genesis.
Waypoints count for everything.
The good news, Space Pigs and TR got Genesis just in time. I bet that TB has tried to do a backup at SRP, but thankfully they're taking Genesis now. So if you're just tuning in, we're basically doing the episode 4 of Outfit Showcase tonight. This time with Space Pigs. And the platoon leader is Pale Tiger. He's the leader of the outfit. Cowboy Blob is second in command, for those of you who don't know.
There's Bad Boss here. Back. Ooh, Bad Boss.
We gotta go through all of this jungle just to see the action.
We get some C4 friends. Take it out. Far side of C point.
The funny thing about the observer camera, I cannot adjust the map when I'm on this mode.
If you have a look at your map, you should see Alpha over there. Alpha can you've got the whole section. You've got Bravo and out to the vehicle terminal almost with that deployment zone. All right.
No resistance here so far, Genesis. We got 79% TR, 24% VS. VS so far is not responding. Except for that one site. Check. Charlie. This guy's trying to climb the 3, but there's no success. Awesome. No response from the VS just yet. And we're currently at Genesis terraforming. And this is what the situation right now is in the map. Awesome. No resistance yet. No change. All 3 points. The main resistance coming from the spawn room. Here comes the main resistance from the spawn room. Alright, here we go. The first line of defense is this little catwalk right near the spawn room. So far, the main VS resistance are a couple of soldiers, specifically these guys.
For you guys, now that I've got a fair few of you guys and I've been organizing you to be on this time this week, just...
Here we go. Some slightly more VS pop rolling in.
Immediately kicked, right? Without any comeback of any racism. Any racism in this outfit, you will be kicked. Right? That is number one rule.
And cheating.
Yeah, hacking is...
They take...
Right, and number three is team killing.
Yeah, as you probably noticed, they're taking their outfit play very, very seriously.
Matt, you will be banned. You will have to go. Alright? We try to make the new game experience the best we can, guys, and we can only do that together by not doing that rubbish. Alright, Bravo, you can move up. Bravo, move up.
Okay, here we go.
To the ground area, like, can you move over to the ground area there and control the ground?
There we go. The main resistance is the spawn room. Barely any VS responding. Hang on a sec, guys. I'm barely getting any audio here. Here we go. Ooh.
Let me know if you want me to go up to the next.
There we go. That was a bit weird. If you're just tuning in, we're basically doing episode 4 of Outfit Showcase right now. And so far we're featuring Space Pigs tonight. It's these guys you see here with their colored names, other than red. And so far what I've seen with Space Pigs tonight is that they take their outfit very, very seriously. They will actually want people to follow their orders, and they don't want them wandering around doing random stuff. So here we go, everybody. Here comes the main resistance.
We should drive up.
This is where the main battle is happening right now here at Genesis.
We have to do an armor push from here, guys. We can have one galaxy, I'm thinking.
This is the main... Here comes the main resistance.
Alpha squad, jump in the galaxy.
VS, TR is still holding.
Go straight over.
So far, there is no other resistance other than the spawn room. And here's Pale Tiger himself. Here's Pale Tiger himself, the outfit leader.
Once you're full,
17 seconds to go. Looking good, Pale Tiger. Looking good. Here, BS is breaching the first room. Here comes the breach. Trying to slow him down, but to no avail. Here comes the first point. They got it just in time.
Pigs. Oi, 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 oi. Squirrel.
They got lucky here. They got very, very lucky. Tiger is just getting swarmed by VS. They got the A point, but they still got the point.
We're gonna mop up. Can I get the next squad? Right. I want Delta and Charlie. Mop up. Alright, I want Bravo in the other galaxy. I want Bravo.
Alpha squad is currently Eastern Substation, ready to take this. All they need is that A point so they can do a cap on Eastern Substation.
It's alright, I'm gonna get A point. I'm going there now.
Yeah, they just need to secure that A point. There we go, they got it. And the action is gonna shift to Eastern Substation. So they also need to capture Ixtab at the same time.
So much longer these days to get to these.
That's it.
Alright, you should be capping now.
Yeah, Eastern Substation is gonna get capped, and Ixtab is gonna get capped. Awesome. Let's go check out Alpha Squad. Let's go check out Alpha Squad, see what's going on over here.
In the balconies, right? Have a look up here. That there, Charlie there, Delta there.
Yeah, decent amount of Alpha Squad. Already ready to go here to defend an Eastern Substation, everybody.
Now, you go in, get up in the veranda. Do not be on the A point sitting there. You only get C4.
Perfect. You got a decent plan going on here. You take these two bases, Eastern Substation and Ixtab, they cannot go back to Genesis. If all of this pop in Genesis moves to both of these territories, they may have a chance to get capture just a little bit more territory. TR currently has the higher pop right now in Hassan.
Wait for, Bravo 12, can you pull up?
Get some spawn.
Oh, here he is. All right, stop.
Here we go.
Pick up the guys.
Here comes the armor convoy. Let's go check it out.
Your squad behind.
Commander, do not go in that parking structure. There's lightning in there.
Let's go.
Here comes the little armor column. Pale's doing.
Six, you should be able to just redeploy, guys. All right, let's push on. Let's get
there. Here comes Commander.
We're still on the A point there. We're still taking it.
Very nice cinematic view for you folks. There we go. Let's follow Commander Keto's Sunder as we go into battle. I just need to boost people's volume as soon as I hear them in voice chat.
Yes, I don't see anybody else. I think
we're going. Oh, here we go. Sunder versus Lightning. Who's gonna win this encounter? Probably the Lightning. Sunder is down. That tank is almost dead. Just a little, it's short health now. They're charging it. I don't think any of them are heavy assault. They can't take it out. Small arms fire is not gonna do anything against this Lightning. Very, very lucky save by this Lightning. Let's go and focus on the main action. VS have taken back this building. My apologies, everybody. I'm trying to boost everyone's volume as soon as they speak in voice chat. VS are swarming all over this base. TR is not in a very good position here. They're getting pushed out. Pale Tiger is trying to hold back, but he just got flanked pretty good.
I'm gonna burn one.
Here comes that backup. Here comes that Alpha Squad gal. VS is getting pushed. VS is pushing them pretty good. They're not gonna have a chance. A valiant effort by Space Biggs, but unfortunately the VS was simply too strong. Yeah, VS just brought in all their pop to counter against TR. So it looks like we're going to be going to somewhere else. Possibly Gurney Dam. Or we could go to the NC front. What's your next move, pal?
Ziggurat.
Ziggurat.
Our next stop is the Ziggurat.
Okay, so they pushed us out of there, right?
Yeah, they got pushed out.
We're going to have to push with armor. We're going to have to push in armor. But here's the thing. They're in that building now. We're not going to be able to get there. So this is one of those bases. I hate to say this, guys. We've got to go. We can't waste our time here. We don't have the time. Yeah, right. Well, it looks like TR's lost alert, but there was a double, full-on double teaming.
Yeah, 7 minutes to go. NC's attacking TR. VS attacking TR.
With combined armor push.
And VTR's getting warp-gated as well. Even though the NC's cut off, but look at that, they're getting warp-gated.
Left is Drexler to Ganna Eastern to Ganna Tech.
Somehow the NC is continuing to warp-gate the TR, even though they have no link. And look at that, SRP Nanite is heading down. Nope, there's no time, nope.
Looks like a big festival there at Gurney Dam.
TR's, via NC's also somehow warp gating, even though we have no link on Nanite. Yeah, with 29 seconds to go, they're somehow getting warp gated.
They've got people on there. We're just going to do an armor push.
Look at this.
Start heading to the waypoint.
Whispering Pass is down, and so far Nanite Relay is not going back to TR hands. What an incredible move by the NC here. Not helping the TR at all, but they are someone in NC is determined to complete this warp gate. And it's by the Goblin Jumpers. It's the Goblin Jumpers. Looks like we're going to be repeating the push at Eastern Substation. Let's join them.
We got a backcap going on here, Terraform. I think we got a stealther.
Yeah, Terraform just got backcapped. Terraforming is going to be what we're going to do now. What looks like the Pale is trying to move a push to Eastern Substation, but looks like he has to do it in 180. But then again, we only got 5 minutes to go. There really isn't much else to go on.
That's the end of my armor. We've got 5 more minutes. Start bringing up the...
Has Amir just got unlocked? Interesting.
Right, we're not going to become cat and fodder with these guys. Everybody redeploy.
Here we go. We're going to go figure out what we're going to do next.
They're coming back to us. All right. We're pushing back here. Let's finish up infantry. Let's do an infantry battle right at genetics. Okay? So I want...
Okay.
...and Bravo to flank to these buildings around there. Right? Charlie and Delta, we're going to take A. Push A.
They're talking about Genesis terraforming. Let's go join them on the ground. Let's be a heavy assault this time.
We've got A here, if that's what you're talking about.
Alright, we'll push out then. Let's push out from there. Well, not there. Rain just rocked up now. Let's push out. We've got 4 more minutes.
Ow. Let's go down these stairs.
I don't know, have a look at the waypoints. Have a look at the way you've got to go, guys. The Delta and Charlie squads, have a look where you've got to go.
Yeah, it's this building right in front of us. Ooh, and they got this whole building locked down. Oh, they got this building pretty well locked down. Hang on a sec, guys. I need to quickly check my controls. Key bindings. When it comes to HUD.
Seriously, Delta. Push up. It's not hard. Bravo. Charlie. If you go to the waypoints where you're supposed to be,
it's a huge 96 plus on Genesis.
Bravo and Alpha, try and get there.
Okay, folks. If you're just tuning in, we're basically doing episode 4 of Up the Chokies tonight. Tonight it's with Space Pigs from Connery. Right now we're dealing with Genesis Terraforming Plant. It's a huge 96 plus Zerg by the VS. I'm gonna show you guys how the battle looks like right now. Instead of dying over and over, we're gonna show you what a battle looks like from above. Let's go do it. Let's leave the spawn room and check out what's going on. And as you can see, VS is everywhere with a 96 plus. The last point that TR has is A. Here comes the VS push. Here comes the VS push, and they're going for that last remaining point, which is A. VS is all over this building, just like that. Multiple outfits I recognize the names of. TWC2, S3X1, and many more. Here comes that Zerg push. VS is pushing to the spawn room now. Look at this VS push.
Up, don't waste your time being maxes and that, because we're about to go to another continent.
Yeah, this base is a done deal.
Everybody, redeploy now to Esimir.
Alright, we're moving on to Esimir. The new Esimir, as a matter of fact.
Everybody redeploy now to Esimir. Everybody get to Esimir now.
Okay.
A little bit of armor push there from there.
Okay, let's move on to Esimir. Let's join Esimir. Let's see what kind of fun we can do here tonight.
Come on, everybody back, get to Esimir. You will get all your points. Remember, you do not lose any of the points. I've received points jumping out of a last alert halfway through, and I got them when I logged in next time. That's what all those points are, guys. Right, just hang on a sec.
I'm letting these guys talk so you get to know what they are like.
Now this is where we start losing our population because it's getting late.
People have to go to work and all that stuff. Stuff happens.
Come on, guys, everybody, you'll get everything. You'll get all your.
Let's see if the voice volumes are okay. Master AC volume is okay. Transmit volume is also good.
The rush too.
Dialogue volume, everything's good.
5 more seconds, guys. Get here now. Start hitting out, getting out to here.
Hey, Pale, put somebody in.
No worries, him.
Charlie, I've got to go.
No worries, Dylan. Jared, there you go. I'll stick some more people in here.
And this is what the new Esimir looks like. We are in the brand new warp gate area, by the way. Let's go and hop in the Gal.
Right, well, Gals are all cheap prices at the moment.
Everyone likes to play Esimir. Other than Indar. Yeah?
Yeah, so when do you want to start doing the other stuff?
We've been doing this for about 45 minutes now, so maybe in another 45 minutes or so.
Can we do it in another 20 minutes?
Sure. Yeah, it's 45 right now, so in about, 20 minutes, yeah.
What's happening is TR, for some unknown reason, when we start getting into this time of night, for the next couple of hours, it just dies off, and then, believe it or not, around midnight, people can't come back on.
That's fine.
Best deployed at ISA Tech Plant, and we have visitors. It's now 3.0 with the map change.
I'm gonna quickly post the Discord link if anybody wants to join to talk about themselves.
We're gonna drop. Yeah. Or you can redeploy. I want the galaxies to drop there, and we're gonna go.
There we go.
And defend the tech plant. Okay.
Sounds good.
So, let's do that. We'll do that for a bit.
Oi, if you're here, get in.
Yeah, Commander.
Bomb squad has diminished to the point where I no longer think we'd be combat effective. Requesting reconsolidation.
There's nothing wrong with what we've done now. We've got plenty of guys in each squad. Once you get used to the outfit and realize that how it is, right, you'll be okay. Normally, we just run 3 or 4 to each squad. So you're lucky to have such a size in your squad right now.
There we go. Let's all start flying. Right. So another 20 minutes or so. So that'll be 9:05 p.m. my time.
Medic in your squad, all right? Alpha squad is all right. Good, Alpha squad. Yeah, Bravo, you got 1, 2 medics. No worries, you got 2 engineers. That's all right. That's just nice. Okay.
Update, Isotech has been, we've secured the points and everything on Isotech. You can go past us.
Esamir has now been stabilized. We could go to Watterson's or the Rink.
I'm just looking at... Nah, I'm looking at these rotten bases. Depends what part of the map you are.
As you can probably tell at this point, Pale has a very, very, very strong opinions.
Left, hard left turn, guys. Hard left turn. Hard left turn. Yeah, hard left turn.
We're going to be doing the amp station. Interesting.
Yeah. Well, that's what we do. VS, we started on, this outfit started on VS. They definitely.
Here we go. Destroy this one turret. Nice air support.
Alright, get ready.
And we're gonna jump.
Have a look. Here we go. Drop.
Perfect timing.
That's a good spread, guys. It's a good spread.
Amp stations have been changed. Instead of 1 point, there are 3 points.
It's going down.
Spawn beacon. Spawn beacons, gentlemen.
Yep.
Yeah, the tech plant is still good.
Is there a vehicle?
Good. They can't back up us unless the NC decides to attack the tech plant also.
Unless we can get a gate diffuser in there.
Bring in one.
But here's the problem. Right? You won't be able to get it out except gate diffuse it out, so yeah.
I don't care about that. Buses are cheap.
So far, the most memorable moment we've had in this episode is when our galaxy unintentionally hit a 3. Let's join Pale Tiger. Where is he? He's over there trying to get rid of that shield. Tonight's going to be a short episode, by the way. It's Pale Tiger's call on this one here. But it's getting late for... It's getting pretty late for where he is at. But we're going along with the show. So here we go, Pale Tiger. He's the platoon leader and the outfit leader of Space Pigs.
The tech plant is getting swarmed with aircraft.
Yeah, we're trying to do a back cap. The NC is trying to do a back cap.
Gate crasher. Are you guys on the tech plant side or
Let's follow him.
So you can drive in, you can hop through.
So far, we're getting all 3 points. Some VS resistance.
Just be careful with the light assault there, cowboy.
Watch out for that turret. So far, we're doing excellent. If you're just tuning in, we're basically doing episode 4 of Outfit Showcase tonight. Cowboy just needs to bring that Sunder back if you can. Then we can get inside.
Can you back onto the doorway so we can jump in?
Yeah, on my way.
He's trying to push it back. There we go.
Jump through.
There we go. Perfect. And just like that, we're inside.
Somebody kill that LA. Somebody kill that LA.
I believe the point is right on the other side. They've remodeled these bases, so I don't remember. Yeah, that guy killed him. Oh, I got him. I got my revenge on Pale. There's that infiltrator. He's down. Nice shooting, Max.
Discord, if you want to jump into the Discord, that we're talking about, right?
Do I have the link? Right,
I gave you the link. I can give it to you again.
Well, I'll figure it out. Just give me a second. Hacking vehicle terminals.
All right, guys, we've been pushed out.
We got about at least another 15 minutes or so before we'll be doing a debrief section.
Everybody, what we're going to do now, we're going to go back to the warp gate, and we're going to do a big armor push, and this is it for the night. Right.
Okay, armor push time.
So, I want everybody back at the warp gate. I want Alpha.
Okay, let's...
Are you kidding me?
Let's go and watch the armor column.
Try and do our own, all right? Amongst it.
Let's go and watch.
I am pulling the Colossus. All right, I am pulling the Colossus.
Here we go, the Space Base Colossus. Let's go check it out.
You want to pull the... You're pulling the Colossus.
I don't have a good one.
Oh, all right, I'll pull it and give it to you.
Cool, thank you, sir.
Here we go. Here comes the VS the Space Pigs Colossus. And Hammered is also, Hammered and Bird is also doing another Colossus or armor column as well.
Well, that's a good looking pile of armor.
Hammered is also doing their ops tonight. That's awesome. So a bit of a Space Pigs and Hammered side by side tonight.
I was there, Tiger.
Alright, jumping, cowboy.
So on the left is Hammered and Bert. Both, they're all Connery outfits as well, and Space Pigs is on the right.
So guys, jump in the guns and the, what's the name?
Two more chairs and the, big chair you're
gonna do. I'm gonna have to decline.
One more chair.
Gonna have to decline.
Two more chairs.
This is an awesome picture to take right now. Here we go. If you want to take a picture of this right now, this is an awesome picture of TR armor right now. Oh, that was awesome. Okay, where did my outfit check go? There we go. It's Bert and Hammered and CIK all together. Looking good.
Does this thing like eat corium as it just sits there, or you use it up as you drive? It's weird. I see a little.
It's for the Skylance mode. Do we have any ants so you won't run out?
Not that I'm aware of.
I guess we're all just waiting here.
It replenishes itself, cowboy.
Oh, thank you, sir.
We also have an ant store, so good as well on that.
I guess we're all just waiting for this armor cone to finally go for the night. Who knows, we might go into the Shard of Warp Gate area. And check out that storm, it's finally moving. That storm's heading straight... the storm is most likely going to go either to Tech Plant or Watersons. Here we go, the armor cone's finally moving.
Just push out with him. Everybody push out with him. Now, cowboy, do not go cross country with that because she does not like it.
Here we go.
Voodoo. That's not voodoo monkey, is it?
Nah, that's not voodoo monkey.
Let's follow this armor column, everybody.
Look at this. That looks pretty mad.
That's voodoo prince, mate. Dang, bro.
Check out this armor co-op. You got a nice cinematic shot of all of the armor all together in one place. What a nice shot. Let's turn off the names. This would be a very nice cinematic shot.
Oh, good on you. The Colossus is like that.
I can't tell who is who, but this looks really great on film.
The massive outfit joint armor push.
That's a lot of cuts.
Oh yes, this is a lot of armor all in one spot.
Don't swear. We're being recorded. Don't swear.
Alright, you got it, mate.
Yeah, we actually got someone actually spotlighting us at the moment.
I think he may have said grunts.
Grunts.
Yeah.
Pretty sure, yeah, he said grunts.
What a beautiful armor car. How many vehicles can you count on screen?
This is for, I'm not recording it, someone else is doing the recording.
Look at this armor car.
If you listen and observe closely, you can see the wild TR in the natural habitat.
True.
Look at this!
I am up on the hill.
Yeah, there's Pale Tiger all the way at the back. Oh no, that's a different one. That's Cowboy, second in command of Space Pigs. Let's see what kind of action we're gonna come across. Yeah, and we already got alerts started. Didn't take very long for that to happen.
Sounds like driving an angry bulldozer.
It's full on in that.
The Colossus is mostly an anti-bastion weapon. That's what that main gun is for.
Looks like we're franking around to Watterson.
Hey! Shoot the enemy air, they're coming for us.
And just like that, and they're gonna be destroying this base. Oh, that poor ant driver, trying to build a base and all of a sudden a huge armor car comes out of nowhere. Yep, his pretty little base is gonna get destroyed just like that.
You must be getting some points there, Amazing Sweep.
Is the guy still there? There he is. I believe this is the guy that's building the base, and unfortunately he's getting shot at. His beautiful base is getting destroyed. He's basically trying to get out of there. He's trying to get away. And he just got shut down. Still got at least another 5 minutes or so to go before we're going to be doing a debrief section. Hang on a sec. Okay, folks, I'm going to give you guys the Discord link. If you're part of Spacepick, if you wish to talk about how long you've been with the group, I'm going to put the Discord link one more time if you guys want to join that. I'll write it down for you.
Apologies, but we cannot hear anything you're saying over command.
I said I'm going to be posting a Discord link once again if you guys wish to join the debrief conversation. We'll be doing that soon. There we go. Alright. Just letting them know that we're going to be doing this conversation here soon. There we go.
Did you get to record that armor push?
Yep, I got it in cinematic style, yeah. This is beautiful to start to end it off with. And here comes that storm! Didn't realize the storm is coming right there. Watch out for that storm! Oh no. It's gonna destroy the armor. Warning, dangerous weather anomaly present.
The most stupidest thing, David, because I'm
ready. Let's get out of here.
And we're finally getting out of here. Everyone's making a run for it. Run away! There's Pale Tiger with his Sunder. They're trying to run the storm.
We're gonna flank around it.
Let's follow Pale Tiger and his Sunder.
Keep pushing around.
Look at all those air. Look at that VS air column. Just shooting down from above. Tiger is trying to evade that storm.
we got the big beastly Cadillac safe. We're good.
Still going. A very short episode on the combat today, but that's all right. Even with at least an hour of this, I got a decent idea on what the kind of group they are. And looks like that storm is heading for Ally Forest Pass. A very intense fight going over there now. Let's go check it out quickly. Oh, hang on a sec, I went the wrong way. Here's the Ally Forest Pass. Our major battle already underway, and that storm is coming over. TR is holding this base pretty good. Here comes that storm. It's gonna kill any infantry or vehicles out in the open. The almighty storm is going to be killing anyone that's in this little circle. And that armor column is making a break for it. Who's gonna get killed by the storm next? VS Pop is slowly dying down. VS is trying to make a push here despite the storm. But they're not getting through. Alright, in a couple of minutes we'll be doing the debrief. If that's what's gonna happen. Unless there's a little base we're gonna be meeting up here. That's where the armor column is at.
Alright guys, this is where we go. Everybody redeploy here. Pull armor from here.
They're still following the armor column, just to finish things off. And we're following Space Pigs tonight, but just pure coincidence, we got hammered and burnt doing armor column tonight.
I got my first kill in Colossus. I feel happy. I feel taller.
He's first to kill. Where is this Colossus? Oh, he's over there. Let's go check it out. Cowboy is all the way over here. What's going on with Cowboy? Oh no, he's already dead. Okay, let's join Pale. If you're just tuning in, we're basically doing episode 4 of Upfit Showcase tonight with Space Pigs, and we're about to be doing the debrief section here soon.
Crazy storm.
Yep.
I really don't like that thing.
Here comes Pale. We're joining this little armor column on top of this hill. Still getting used to this observer camera.
Can he get to our waypoint? Where we are, this is where the rest of Hammond went. Oh my god.
He's still going, they're still going. Hale's trying to catch up. Beautiful armor column. Witness the firepower of the Terror Republic tanks.
That's where we're heading.
Okay guys, let me find out where we're going. Oh, there we are. We're back there. Holy moly.
Alright, let's follow this armor column. Pigs is already following them as well.
We are on our way.
Hey, can we take a quick stop to repair the tank?
Yeah.
Squad lead, do I have time to grab a brew?
Yeah. We gotta grab a brew. Oh, this is bad. When you want to do this interview and that, I'm just warning you, my internet's about, this time of day it starts playing up because people get home. Australia is actually going to fix, have started fixing the internet. But yeah.
That's a first.
We can wrap this up soon here. Oh boy, look at that. Here comes the VS column. Ow, they got wiped out.
Run.
Oh, almost got run over. Ow. Looks like the VS is hunting down an armor column. And there, it looks like they're about to. Yeah, they've got a harasser squad. They're going after this armor column. Well, I think that's about it. We're going to be going to the debrief section after this. So, Pale, do you want to do the interview thing or debrief section now? Or you guys want to keep going?
Right, just hang on a sec. I'm back at Warp Gate where I can talk. Are you ready to do the interview?
Yeah, we can do that right now. And anybody here that wishes to join in.
Alright, I will give the platoon lead to someone else so I can talk to you freely and I don't have to look at the game. And that, just give me a moment.
And by the way, guys, I'm going to give you guys the Discord link once more, and I'll give you the instructions of platoon chat what to do. Here we go, guys. We're going to be talking with Paystigs themselves.
Okay, who can take over the... I'm not leading the game, but can I have someone running? It's a new outfit, 69TS. How old's that? It must be only a few weeks.
Again, it's like I can barely hear that guy.
Friends, you're quite welcome to join us, join our outfit anytime. But yeah, all right,
thanks, mate.
All right, here we go. I'm looking. Who is? I'm looking at who's in the interviews. Just
yeah, Pale. You can just turn the game voice off or something like that. I'm gonna be turning my game off also just to focus on Discord. So for those of you that don't.
Commander, you have the room. It's yours. You have it.
Thanks again for lending your time to show off of how you guys play in-game. I appreciate the time you guys give. So I'm going to be logging off here to talk with Space Pigs. So if you guys want to join it, I already gave the link there. But again, stay safe out there, guys. Thanks for having me. All right, I'm gonna quit this game out of the way here. One sec. Exit the game. I'm gonna be switching it to outside game view right now. One sec. Let's do that right now. One sec. Okay. All right. Let's bring this over. Here we go. Hang on a sec. Okay, folks, thanks for coming by. Is Bilbo here? In a sec, let me see if I can get a hold of him. Because we're all going to be talking on Discord here now.
Okay.
In a sec.
We've got... I'm going to put the kettle on quickly. If you need to... anything I know or even know... Well, Cowboy mostly know more about this game than I do. All right? And he's up there with it. So I'm just going to put the kettle on. PRP.
No worries. Yeah, I'm just gonna give gonna wait a little bit if any more people from in game wanna come over and join the discussion.
Yeah, understood.
No worries.
Yeah, it looked like they were carried away running around blowing stuff up. I'm gonna grab a Gatorade. I'll be back in a moment.
No worries. Hey, nothing wrong with Gatorade, huh?
Oh no, I just harkened back to Waterboy. That's my childhood. Gatorade.
Those Gator commercials you were talking about?
H2O.
All right. So normally the episode would go a bit longer, but I guess Pale wanted to end it sooner because it's getting pretty late and the situation Connor is a bit different. So I can see why. Just by pure coincidence, Hammered and Bird were also doing their armor ops nearby.
Yeah, we went with them.
Very convenient.
We got invited actually to do it with them through command chat, and so we went there. So one of the boys went there first and said something. Mm-hmm. And we realized so on command chat. I said, "Could we follow you?" And they went, "No problem. It's all good."
Okay, I'm gonna drag you guys over to this room here, so we will not have random people popping in. But I can definitely drag other people if they come in late. One sec, I'm going to drag you guys in.
That's gorgeous.
So, welcome everybody. Thanks for taking your time here to talk with me here. So, let's dive into how everything's turned out tonight. It was pretty short. I think the first thing out of the bat, I don't know if you guys noticed it, but when I was in one of the gals back in Hassan, I think one of the gals hit a three, so it was pretty awkward when we tried to get to one of these bases.
yeah. Well, that's the norm. Hossen, like I said, it's very hard. It's air only, really. We've tried doing armor pushes and all that, but you're limited. There's no shortcuts. You can't do nothing on Hossen when it comes to vehicles.
Yeah. It's
definitely air. It's definitely air. Like, you move around by air, and that's the way. Even though the trees are a hassle, it's still, you get used to it, and a lot of the guys are pretty good.
So let's shift the conversation back to you, the outfit yourself. So before we start off talking each of you here, so I think you can, I think you or Cowboy can answer this question. It's completely up to you. So look, a little brief history of Space Pigs. How did the group start out, and how is it now?
Well, I started Power Riders. I came from Power Rider outfit on Briggs to Connery, right?
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And I created a Power Rider outfit on VS, and that's where I met Cowboy pretty much straight away. And him and me have been like building up these outfits all along. So we've built it up from 6 years ago. We started the Power Rider on VS on Connery, right?
Mm-hmm.
Anyway, we were playing the game. What happened was the Wildcards, who the larger outfit on VS on Connery, started just ghost capping territories, like going off on other continents. So when the final alert, back then you'd be lucky to get an alert. And if you got an alert, normally you got a pretty quick, like a really good weapon, stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
But anyway, they constantly just ghost capped other continents. They never played the alert. So what had happened was we decided to create an outfit on TR to fight the wild cards to get them to play the game.
Mm-hmm.
And we ended up liking. So Cowboy and I and a few others stayed on TR. We, not everybody. I mean, there's still 500 members in that outfit of 6 years ago. No one's running it. It's on.
Mm-hmm.
I gave it to someone. They didn't continue on. And that, so yeah. But that's how we sort of started. Now we fight mainly VS and the wildcards. We're not just, how can I say it? It's more too. We talk about a lot of things on here. Computers, obviously, because it's a computer game. We talk about computers and all that. But it's settings. It's all our settings and that in the game, how we make this game for everybody good. But the main thing is that the settings, a lot of people don't like fighting VS because they're dark purple and they reckon they can't see them in the daytime. And, of course, you set your monitor. Most monitors have a black equalizer, right? A lot of people mostly don't even realize they've got it. You can use that. But if you don't have black equalizer, use cinema or movie. It's the same thing, does the same thing, same outcome and that. But yeah, but that's why we fight VS, we fight the wild card. That's what we're really all about. That's why you might have noticed we were hitting there. But anyway, yeah, Cowboy.
One part that that kind of follows up after what Tiger says, we created a TR outfit. I think that was just for scrubs, just to shoot at people in
mm-hmm.
card. And yeah, we liked it, and we thought, hey, let's switch over. This is not the easy button. There's, you know, we do have bullet drop and such. And so we started building up a Pale Rider equivalent on TR, which got pretty large. And then I'm not sure how much Planet Side 2 you play, but whenever there's a update, there's kind of this random grab bag. It's kind of like playing a TV Jeopardy game where you open door number 3 and something horrible happens due to bugs in the update. So one of the updates, it basically destroyed our Pale Rider on TR. It just blew the whole outfit up. Just randomly.
Yeah. Yeah,
and so we're kind of sitting there going, okay, what do we do now? Because over 1,000 people or, you know, player characters and such. And we go, well, you know, what are you going to do? What are we going to do? Not really getting a response from the devs because they're too busy trying to, you know, fix the burning barn that was underway. So Tiger brilliantly looked through the different decals, saw a pig smoking a cigar, and went, there it is, space pigs.
Cool.
So this is like our, what is this, our fourth or fifth outfit we've created now?
Yep. Yep.
And this is the most popular one out of all of them. And I have no idea maybe why. Maybe the vision of pigs battling in space makes people think of bacon, which is the candy of meats, and makes them happy.
Yeah. Well, that's pretty much it. Cowboys just basically said, but we did make this outfit more pleasable for everybody, because the other outfit we only had an Australian flag at the decal. I still actually got that old outfit. Everything sorted itself out. I ended up with the old outfit back, but by then we started this. But I actually do have a dummy account on the old Power Rider outfit on TR. So actually we had it's quite strange what happened. There was, in the early day, there were a lot of glitches that did some weird stuff to the game and to the people. You get a situation where there was a period of time. That was the time where you logged on and you weren't in your outfit anymore.
There was the one where you got randomly booted out of the outfit. And that was when we discovered the value of having the first person in the outfit in the database on the server. That if you're in the number one slot, even if you're a low rank, if something happens to the outfit, it will default to slot zero, if you're thinking in terms of rows and like an SQL database or something like that. And luckily, I was in that position, or we would have lost that outfit at that time as well.
Yeah.
So
I think I'll go back.
So let's, yeah, no worries. Thank you for that information on that, on your outfit there. So I'm gonna continue to shift this conversation along. So we're gonna take some questions from the audience. If you guys have any questions for Space Pigs, now is your chance. So for next thing we're gonna do is I'm gonna allow you guys to talk a little bit about yourselves. So Akito, yeah. So I don't know how long you've been with Space Pigs, but we're going to be going through each one of you in the same way for this first question. So how did you join Space Pigs in the first place, and how is your experience with them when you first started, and how is it now? So Akito, you got the floor. Tell us a little bit about yourself.
Well, let's see. I started out in a platoon or a outfit not too long ago. I'd say I've been in War Pigs about 3 weeks now, something like that. And I left another outfit to join Warpig, seeing how they got results, and also most importantly, they were more active and actually cared about the results of capturing bases and more or less mentoring people for the betterment of the entirety of faction of TR.
All right, you got anything else to add there? No.
Well, I'd say that Tiger here is a fairly effective commander, if you will. He certainly has a grip on the grander strategy of things. Ongoing with constant battlefield, and I feel like I can stand beside him, and we attain victory if we just concentrate all efforts.
All right, I see we got some viewers coming in. So if you guys have any questions for Space Pigs, now is your chance. So the next person we're gonna be talking to is Amazing Sweet. So you have the floor, Sweet.
So I was initially recruited by Tiger at least a year and a half ago.
Okay.
I had my mic issues. I was building a new PC at the time.
That was longer than that. You've been in the outfit, right, for nearly 2.5 to 3 years.
Oh, there you go. I had mic issues for at least 8 months because there were some screwy settings I was unaware of. But I can say I've played other factions. I've played Vanu, debatably the most hated faction in the entire game, and I've played New Conglomerate. There are some technical differences between the firearms and the tank deploys and strategic overlay of how they actually play, but to be perfectly honest, I mean, I've never been in another unit that is more renownedly hated for the best reasons ever than Space Pigs, and You know, it's funny because if you start a random squad and your tag is pigs of any stripe, you'll find that you'll get people joining your squad for no reason other than your clan that you have, because they know, look, you guys play the objective. You don't screw around. You know, if you wanna build bases in the middle of nowhere, that's fine, but you should probably go back to Minecraft. That's not this game. You play the objective, you stick with your teammates, and you do your bit, whatever it is. And it's refreshing because, you know, no matter what role you're in, if you're in a support role, great. There's literally always a need for that. If you're an attack role, great. There's always a need for that. If you're in a recon role, great. There's always a need for that. I mean, it doesn't really matter how you play. We need you, basically. And also, I find that this squad, this group, more renownedly has people that have mics. And that is not an under or overshadow. It's if you are in a unit and you can, you know, cohesively talk with people on your squad or just general, you know, command chat, you're at least 50% more effective just because you're not screwing around in the middle of the jungle. And I say that not really too lightly because there's a lot of that going on. But if you play the objective and then you can redeploy and then you're on the objective again in 2 minutes, you're like constantly punching the enemy. And I'm not too surprised at why we're the most hated unit, because we're the most organized. And whenever there's a major event, we're the group they are not looking forward to facing because of that. So I deeply appreciate being in this. And I've known Tiger for a little while. I've only really listened to him speak just because he's a talker and I'm not going to interrupt him, and he's charismatic, so let him do his thing. So it's entertaining nonetheless. But
so it's nice. Go ahead. All right.
No,
no worries. So Cowboy Blob is up next. Now, only thing I know about you, Cowboy, is that you are second in command of this whole group. Is that right?
I call it co-owners. We both own the lease. Yeah.
So, Cowboy, so how did you start off with this group in the first place, and how? Like, can you tell us briefly of your journey from this game, if you will, how you came into this group and how it is now. Go ahead.
Yeah, absolutely. I was actually an EverQuest 2 player.
Oh, nice.
Playing Battlegrounds. I was a Fury. I was like 84,000 kills and stuff like that, and started getting bored looking around. That was back when it was SOE down on down off of Camino Ruiz. And I'd go down there. They had parties down there. They always had good beer. They didn't buy the cheap stuff. And I always saw banners for different products and stuff. And I thought, well, you know, I see a lot of people talking up Plant Side. I'll go check it out. I hopped in there. I was running from base to base. I had no idea how to play the bloody game. Running from base to base. And finally, I found somebody and I shot them in the head. And I was hooked. And I don't know if that's something I should be concerned about myself. As long as I don't do that in real life, I think I'm okay. But didn't know anything about the factions. Joined Vanu because I VS because I went, oh, space alien, woohoo. Declined every invite to an outfit because I was just doing solo. Got an invite from Tiger and went, yeah, okay, I'll try this. And since then, we've been on this, I call it reckless journey. And between the pair of us, neither one of us makes a major decision without the other one's input. And that is a nice stabilizing mechanic for the outfit. So you don't get these crazy gyrations that you might see in another one where somebody who's leading the outfit has a bad day and then kicks everybody with too many vowels in their name or something like that. We jointly make decisions, so it adds good stability. And since then, a lot of what Tiger said earlier regarding all the different history of the outfit. And then we had the first outfit wars, which was pretty sweet for us, because everybody thought we were going to get smoked, and we won.
That's so, it. We won the gold. The gold outfit was won the top award on the server.
So quick question for you, Blob. I know we're trying to go for a good time here, but so Blob, so what's the story of becoming co-owner of the group or co-leader or whatever you want to call it? What's the story behind that?
I'd say trust. Many times, as I mentioned, where the outfit would wind up in a situation where one person, where if I was untrustworthy, I could have destroyed it. I could undermine it and such. And Tiger and I have known, worked together in this long enough that we do implicitly trust one another. And that takes time. That always takes time. And also the opportunity to succeed or fail. And we've seen it in other outfits where somebody has the opportunity to grab the reins and then just start making horrifying decisions. You know, the name Leroy Brown, oddly enough, comes to mind. And they take a really good outfit and they can wreck it. And then it winds up as a difficult situation to pull it back and all kinds of trouble. So both Tiger and I have had the opportunity where we're presented with that decision. What path do you take? And we always take the noble path.
How long have you known Pale, and how long have you been co-owner with him?
I'd say, 6 years, 7 years?
It's close to 7. It's nearly 7 because I'm definitely been with, what's her name? Quinta, whatever her name is. I'm still on her Facebook. I've been friends with her, and it says 7 years. So I don't know how, but I must have moved over pretty quickly from bloody Briggs to Connery if it's that long.
So
because I only met her when you met her, remember, Cowboy?
Yeah.
So, Blob, sorry to interrupt, but Blob, when it comes to being co-owner of the group, how long has that been? How long has that been? Or is it about the same?
It's been... basically the same, I would say. Would you agree, disagree?
Yep, I agree to that.
Okay, so just because you're up next, sorry for keeping you waiting here, now's your chance to tell us a little about yourself, how you start off with the game, how do you come across the group, and how has it been ever since?
Let's see. I am pretty sure one of the youngest on this god-awful server and god-awful outfit, but it is definitely fun. I joined after a spree of getting back into the game after getting bored with some other stuff. And I was in the platoon with Tiger, and he found I had a mic, added me, and we just kind of had fun with that. The pigs are pretty fun. They're pretty hardcore at the game, so it's nice to grind out stuff with them because they actually focus on objectives and everything else that's needed instead of going off and doing shenanigans somewhere else. So other than that, yeah, it's kind of fun with them.
All right. And the next thing I want to tell you guys, I just want to talk a bit, is what's the most memorable moment you've had with this game so far? Now, this could be with the outfit you're playing, or it could be with any other group you'd be playing with. So again, without thinking too much, what first comes into mind when it comes to the most memorable moment you had with the game so far? So Keto, you're up first.
Apologies, my response is going to be brief. I am commanding the entire platoon. Either way, I'd say that my most memorable moment is when we had a huge armor column essentially come rolling up from one warp gate all the way straight up to the other warp gate. I'm on the current planet I'm on. I'm trying to remember it. Esimir, it is, yes. Warpix was there when I was first joined them essentially that day. And we all just got a huge armor columns and completely captured the entire map before it even opened. And then when it fully opened, we completely dominated. All I saw on my screen was nothing but TR capture points. And we literally just sat there and camped the ever-living crap out of the new conglomerate because they couldn't do anything. We were just a force of nature at that point.
Was this a week ago? I'm pretty sure I was there for that.
Akito, was this a week ago? Just because he's asking.
Yes, that is. That was only just a week ago.
Yeah, I remember that.
We tend to project our power very broadly, and when we do, we get results, and that's the important part. We actually get stuff done.
All right. So, Cowboy, same question to you. What comes into mind?
That's an easy one.
What?
First outfit wars.
Oh.
Winning that thing was what I viewed as a culmination of a long journey. Also going in as the absolutely severe underdogs. But I'm not sure if you noticed as you're observing the gameplay earlier between Tiger and myself, how we look at the map and we're viewing and we're discussing different tactics, cutoffs and such. We don't just jump from base to base. We're kind of the blue collar, smash your face into a wall relentlessly. We actually look at things tactically and play it like a chess game. And that's how we played that first outfit wars, is that we sat there and we made decisions and we made moves tactically. So it was kind of abstracted up one level from just point and shoot. And it worked tremendously well. I was very proud of everybody involved. And yeah, I call that the high point for me.
If you, let's say, is there any other high point? Just curious, is there any other high point outside of Outfit Wars that you could think of that really stood out? Or was that the only one that really comes to mind?
Oh, no. There's many things have gone well. And of course, many things have gone sideways.
One that
sticks out is we closed out a continent.
Mm-hmm.
Hopped onto, it was Esimir. There was about 2 minutes left. We were behind, and it was myself and Freak and, you know, some of the other folks. And we're casually looking at the map. I was platoon lead at the time, and command channel was full of a lot of squawking and screaming because it was close.
Mm-hmm.
And Freak and I, you know, we look at the map and we go, let's take that one base there and we'll win. Okay, casually load up the galaxies, get everybody in there, drop on it, took the base, and one closed out that continent, winning it with like about 5 seconds to spare. And we were, but what made it fun was we were so calm about it. It was like we were going to the grocery store to buy some corn and milk, and everybody was flipping out, and we were like, yeah, okay, I guess we'll just win this continent. Okay, there we go. It was amusing and satisfying.
Like a boss moment, right?
Yeah, I don't know. I don't like the term boss. I prefer leader.
Oh, yeah. But you get the idea. Yeah.
But we were so casual. It was like firefighters just casually walking into the burning building and carrying babies out in a grocery bag.
Right.
And all the babies lived, and you go, okay, well, I guess we'll go get a sandwich and a beer now.
So just because, same question to you, what comes into mind?
Let's see. I probably have had better in the past, but most recent was unfortunately not in this platoon because I haven't been with them too much in the past week. I was playing with another, and we decided to screw around as Astartes. So we loaded up roughly 2 galaxies completely filled with maxes and rushed an open point after we bombarded them and completely rolled them over after they were about to cap the point. And of course, they were screaming in a yell chat constantly about it. So that was fun.
So Pale, the big man himself. I mean, what's the most memorable one that comes into you? I think afterwards the most obvious one. I mean, if you want to talk about that, that's completely up to you. But also another thing that I'm also interested to hear is outside of awards, if anything else comes into mind. So please, Pale, go ahead.
All right. Well, I definitely agree with Cowboy and that whoever was on that day. We did training right up to Outfit Wars, like training. And I trained. I didn't have a plan. There was no plan, really. All right. I kept everybody wanted to have a plan. And what are we going to do? I said, you don't need a plan. You need to be able to follow your squad leader. This is why I do the squad setup, getting people into that. Right. Mm-hmm. So I think you stick, or normally we run with formatic stuff like that, but that's how we won. We beat Recursion, which was the number one outfit in the game. And the reason why we beat them is that in that game and outfit wars, everybody's the same. We even had a shortage. The nanites you had in the first outfit war, that's it. Once you used them up, you didn't get any more back, right?
Mm-hmm.
You think. So it came down to basically hand-to-hand combat with recursion and that, right? And that's why we beat them, because recursion got put on an equal footing to us, and that's why they lost. See, they've always been an outfit that uses, exploits. That's it.
Oh.
Exploits. Yeah. And of course, Outfit War map is a new map, right? No one knows the exploits, if there is any exploits on that map. It looks pretty bare, right? So they were forced, and we slaughtered them. They came last out of the 9 battles that were raging at that time. They came last, and that says something. Because I've always been sus of that outfit, but it says something. They got the lowest point. They got 170 something points. The next set of points came from an outfit that did bronze. They had 400, right? Yeah. The rest, everybody was above. You know, and that's the thing. But that's why that game's so important, you know, to us. It's because everybody was we beat an outfit that was forced to have to play the game the way we've got to play it all the time. You know, that's why it was so big. But if you had to say, apart from the outfit wars, what else there was, it was the best battle we had was about a year ago, where we jumped from one continent to the other and basically locked 3 continents in a row. There was 2 already open. We'd locked 1 down and the other 2 had short term. We managed to get through and jump around to all 3 and win them and turn it around. You know, and that sort of stuff. And we do a lot of the gal drops because it's all about speed. As for plans, basic plan I have in everything I do is create a situation where a possible crossfire from squad cross-firing with another squad at the enemy. And that's what I try and do. Always try and get the enemy in a crossfire and that the best I can. You know, terrain normally messes that up. But as a rule of thumb, it does work and that sort of thing. But as for planning, I found that in this game, you've got to keep it simple, stupid. That's the way you've got to play it. Even in outfit wars, you can't be planning big, elaborate things to do, right? The more you put in people's head, the more they've got to remember, the more they're going to forget.
It's also like herding cats.
Yeah, that's it. But we got everybody to follow their squad leads, and that's what won it for us. It wasn't the tactics, it was the actual training of guys sticking and reviving and repairing and doing all that in their individual squads. I'd been practicing beforehand, weeks before, holding points, knowing we're outnumbered, but with only 1 squad. And we lasted at Snowshear, with the old Snowshear. We lasted there for half an hour on a point when we were doubly outpopped, and that was on a point. And that we lasted half an hour, 1 squad. And that was people reviving them for reviving and stuff like that, ammunition. And that's how it worked. And I got people to understand that it's not the plan of the attack. It's the coordination of the players. That's how it works. That's the best. So,
exactly. This game, as you folks probably know already, this is... Are you okay, Pierre?
Yeah, sorry.
Okay, so... As I was just saying, I think you guys know this already, and I think the audience also knows this, but I'm going to say it anyway. Planet Side 2 is a team-based shooter. It's not individually skilled. I mean, even you alone, it's not going to help win the battle. You basically need teamwork, kind of like other games you probably know already, but specifically, Planet Side 2 is a team-based shooter, and you can have over 96-plus people in one area in particular. There might be some slowdown, but I can't think of many other games that can do over 200 plus people in one area. That's what the things this game has. So, looking at the time, we still got at least another 20 to 25 minutes. So, let's talk about some fun things here. So, Akira, I know you're kind of busy here, but we're going to be asking everybody the same thing here. So, let's talk about some fun things. So,
I don't know if you space pigs have some funny memes or memorable memes going on around, but you can also talk about any planetside to me if you want to talk about that. So I don't know. I don't know if we can post pictures here, but you can describe it. So Akita, what's the most memorable or funny PS2 meme or your group's meme that you can think of right now that you want to tell us?
Well, I've had quite a few funny moments, if you will. I'd probably say a funny moment would be
memes, or moments, whatever.
Memes, moments, yes. Probably a funny meme or something like that I've seen myself is I was flying a galaxy with my platoon,
mm-hmm.
and essentially, the enemy galaxy also flew over us and somehow managed to land itself upside down onto my galaxy, and I couldn't take off. So we had to literally C4 the other galaxy off it before we can hot drop right onto the right back onto the enemy base.
Did your gal survive that or no?
Well, you see, our galaxy did survive it up until the point we got shot down by a lightning somehow.
Oh, it kind of reminds me of construction object clipping through things in a way, but that's completely unrelated. So, Cowboy, is anything, any memorable memes or moments happening in the game that you can think of?
I'm just looking through screenshots here to see if anything really jumps out.
Well, what comes into mind?
Many things.
Go ahead.
Not many of them useful. Oh, geez. Why don't you come back to me? How's that?
A little context to that?
Oh, wait. Here we go. And it comes with a shout out, too. For those who remember Rumble Tough.
I don't remember that one. Go ahead. Who's that?
Rumble Tough was actually the founder, and he ran TWC. Really good guy. And he wound up with vision problems, and that's why he is unable to play anymore. So he would set up these battles between the different factions, kind of, we're going to do a harasser race and stuff like this. And he put a lot of work into it. It was very well received, and it was a lot of fun. And one of them was the Galaxy Knife Fights. Remember those, Tiger? Basically, you would take a whole bunch of galaxies from all three factions. You stick them up in the air, and you have light assaults with knives, fighting, jumping from galaxy to galaxy. I'd say that was a pretty darn good one. Doesn't sound as good when I say it, but it was a heck of a lot of fun when we did it.
So how were these galaxies positioned? Like, were they very, very close together, or?
Let's see here. I apologize for the wide screen. I run almost 6,000 horizontally. Oh, it did not upload. I'm going to try it again here. I'm going to scale it down. They were just basically a blob of galaxies, if you will.
Oh, yeah.
And I have some screenshots here of them kind of assembling.
If you can post it on the PST media then when you get the chance. It's just below us there. So yeah. While you're doing that, Cowboy, was there any grand prize or anything like that if you're the last one standing? No, just bragging rights?
No, just fun. Just bragging rights and fun. And it was. I mean, like I said, it was very well received. And a lot of effort he put in. And I give him a shout out. I mean, I feel very bad for what he went through, that he's not able to play anymore.
Who was the leader of TWC again? What was his name?
Rumble Tough.
Shout out to Rumble Tough there. I'm not too sure if he's going to be seeing this recording right now or in the future, but just a quick shout out to him.
Yeah.
So is that the
a lot of respect for that guy.
What is that the same group that's now TWC2 or they're not related?
Yeah. They're related.
Yep.
So
it's a high, sorry, it's a love hate relationship.
Why is that?
Oh, well, because they are our enemy. You know, and we take this game pretty seriously, but they are the opposition. They were the wildcards were the reason. Rumbletuff did a lot of ghost capping, and they were the reasons why we created the outfit. So, but as a person, Rumbletuff's a nice bloke.
Yeah, well, we separate the game and real life, you know.
Okay, so just curious. I'm not sure if you're keto, cowboy, or pale when I answer this question, but where did this rivalry, if you want to call it, start between the two of you?
Back when we were on VS, same faction as them.
Oh, okay. So TWC and TWC2, it started off as TWC and then it's changed to TWC2, or they're both the same?
They're both the same. They're two separate outfits. One's on TR and one's on VS. The VS is the main.
So
they can pull together at any time. At any time Rumble jumps on, they can pull together three platoons at any time right now as we speak.
They're still like that nowadays, right?
Yeah, they're pretty big. They rely on numbers mainly.
Yeah, they're absolutely huge. And they're like Tiger said, they're able to pull together a heck of a response, and they have really good pilots. Their pilots are scary.
In all aircraft or only specific ones?
Scythes, which of course is there's a lot easier to fly than the other ones, but that doesn't distract from their skill. I mean, some of those pilots are just freaking amazing what they do. But that's coming from a guy who can't fly to save his life.
Yeah, no worries. Even personally, I'm not a good flyer myself. Still trying to learn it if I'm even going to grasp it someday. So, Pal, I know you posted a YouTube link there. I just saw it now. So,
yeah.
What is that YouTube link about?
That's a meme about me. Right?
Oh, is that the one that Cash Meow did?
No. This is the one that Conflict did a long, long time ago.
Mm-hmm.
Right? The Star Wars.
Yeah. Oh, that thing was awesome.
Yeah. Now you have to watch this privately, right? Because you can't stream it, all right? Because you'll get banned. But it's something that someone put together. I ended up putting the voice to it. I could send you the original link. I'll do that. That doesn't have any swearing in it, all right? So you can have both. Just hang on a sec.
You can post it on PS2 Media or NSFW here if you want. So looking at the time here, we're still doing good on time here. So let's do some closing statements and remarks. So I know you're kind of busy right now, Keto, but we're basically going to repeat some statements over and over again. But I wanted to have you have your chance to say to the audience on maybe about the game, maybe should they join your group, etc., etc. So if you happen to have some time to talk, Keto, this is your chance.
I'm an amazing multitasker, don't worry about it, man.
Well, anyway, Keto, you what do you want to say to the audience when it comes to closing statement remarks, why they should join your outfit, etc., or this game for that matter? Go ahead.
Well, I would say that they would probably want to join they will want to join Pigs. For the matter of the fact is that we get stuff done, and more importantly, we are organized. We actually have communications running, and we get results as a consequence of this. And from there on out, we should be able to easily, I'd say, with come next outfit for outfit wars, and if you hone your skills enough and spend enough time with us, your efforts will not go unnoticed, and your efforts will be rewarded. And most likely, if you're good enough, you might just make it into the next outfit wars. Who knows? That's up to PL though. Or cowboy, but I certainly hope that I make it in myself. I've been training and I train hard, and I know for a whole bunch of guys here who commit a lot of hours to these games in order to improve their aim, improve their tactics, and overall improve the cohesion and ability to fight like absolute hogs, if you will.
And before I move on to cowboy here, you just posted another link on Twitch there. So is this the censored one that you're talking about?
Well, the top one's the top one's the censored one. The bottom one's the not like is okay to play, right?
Okay, gotcha.
So if you copy and paste it and put it somewhere,
we can. Do you want me to play that right now for you live on stream?
Well, do the bottom one first. Don't do the swearing one, unless you can. It's up with the first one is the best one.
Okay, I'll do the bottom link for you then.
Yeah, do the bottom link. The top one will make your grandmother blush.
Okay, yeah. I'm doing the bottom link now. Hang on a second. I'll get it on screen for you guys here. Hang on. It's about a 2-minute long clip here. Do you want me to play it in its entirety or only certain bits?
You got to play the whole thing. It's golden.
Okay, well, let's do that. Here we go. Let's do it. Everything's on HD.
2 minutes of your life.
Okay, sure. All right, yeah, it's got a name of conflict. Is this that guy that TWC you were talking about, or
is completely? No, he's Recursion.
Oh,
he's a friend. He did this. The Recursion and Pigs, where there's a triangle, a love triangle with Recursion, Wildcards, and Pigs.
Okay, well, anyway, let's get this video started, and I'm not gonna play this completely uninterrupted, and this will be my reaction, so I'm gonna start focusing on this, and this was released back in 2018. Alright, here we go. I'm gonna watch this for the very first time. I don't know about this video, I think, but here we go.
There's no sound. Oh, yeah.
He might be enamored with it.
See, they were having go at me because I always called them hackers. Yeah, I said they always have aimbot.
Surprising. That was 2 years ago already.
Yep.
Yeah, time flies in a pandemic.
Well, nearly three, actually, January. So we're going in. Yeah. We're only a couple of months off, so.
Time flies when you have a pandemic.
Yep. Have you got sound, Cowboy? I can't hear
it. I can hear it, yeah.
Oh, you should have did the top one, then you would have laughed if only you could hear it.
Wish you were here for this, Tiger. There's fire from the sky and chaos everywhere.
Yeah. The first Araxicon where it said Bert, we had a problem with Bert outfit and we ended up destroying him. Constantly team killing.
I don't recognize many of these names.
No, they're all conflict a while ago. Yeah, but it's all Connery server.
Okay. I don't know much to say about that. I mean, I know it's a take on Rogue One with all the Connery names there, but you want to tell me a little bit about those names there, because they just went over my head. I didn't really know what was going on there.
Well, here's the thing. When you listen to the other one, right, the story, because that's why I did a voiceover later on. I asked his permission to do that. He said, yep, I did a voiceover. But I've all accused them all of hacking, right? And that's the basis of the story. We had a internal war with Bert, which Pigs won. That's why you see the Bert base in the beginning being blown up. And, of course, we're taking off. I'm Darth Vader. But I'm considered the bad guy on this server. That's the truth of it, right? I'm the person you've got to get. That sort of thing. Our outfit is what's got to, you've got to get. It's sort of thing. There's that many memes. If you ever put Pale Tiger for memes, you'd be shocked how many comes up. It's just one of many videos and that sort of stuff. But anyway, at the end of it sort of thing, they've made me as Darth Vader and all that. I'm the bad guy. If you read, I know a lot of those players, and I actually say something in that their name and thing. I know them all, actually. And here's the thing. It's like, it's got to the point, there's that many parodies and carry on about me, it's not funny. I can either be the most loved player in this game or I'm most hated, one or the other, and that sort of stuff. But it's like, we constantly hit VS, we constantly hit recursion, and we're constantly a pain in the butt. That's what we do. We constantly are there. We're never, you know, there's no battles where there isn't a pig running around and that sort of thing. But that's some of the memes that they've got. That's one meme that Conflict made up.
So I think I already asked Cowboy, and I already asked you, Pale, for this moment, right? Did I? I'm just trying to remember.
I think you left off at Aikido regarding the pros, or, you know, shout out for the why somebody would be interested in the outfit and what have you.
I think Aikido already answered that question, I think.
Yeah, he did.
And I think, Cabo, you already answered that question, or you haven't had your chance yet?
Not yet.
Okay, well, Cabo, this is your chance. So sorry for dragging on a little bit there.
No worries. I would say that one of the biggest benefits for joining this outfit, it is very supportive of new players. And if we're running a platoon and somebody's new and they're not in an outfit and they're not even going to join us or anything like that, they will help them, and Tiger's actually very well known, and people have done shout outs on that, like Sirius and such, about the effort to make the game hospitable for new people, because without new blood the game dies, and we understand that, and, you know, it's kind of keeps the lights on. But when it comes to the outfit itself, important things, and Tiger mentioned it earlier, no racism. We don't tolerate it. That's insta-ban gone. No cheating, no hacking. Insta-ban gone. We have fun. We have day jobs, we have lives, we have a pandemic, we have Christmas coming, we have real lives. So main thing is to have fun. And we don't treat it like a career decision. So those are some of the key components to it. And therefore, it's kind of welcoming. There are outfits and platoons where you hop in and somebody's screaming at the top of their lungs and they're, you're 3 seconds late. You need to be at that base. You need to be facing west. Why are you wearing those shoes and all that kind of nonsense? And my first thought is, hey, buddy, I got a job. I got a real life. I don't need this from you. So we understand that. And that kind of builds a good community. We do have people leave the outfit and come back. They miss it. And that says something. So there's my shout out on it.
Thank you, Cowboy. And again, it's a bit of a repeat what Aikido said, but I'm having you guys have your take and version on how you guys want to say this to the audience. So, Pale Tiger. So what do you want to say to your audience in your take version? Go ahead, you have the floor.
All right. Well, here's the thing about pigs and how I create things. I am ex-military years ago when I was a young fella and that sort of stuff. And this game is not a military game. All right. It's a space game. It's as simple as that. There's a lot of things and a lot of stuff in that can happen at all times, right? And what I'm trying to say is we lead and we do things out of the ordinary, right? The only thing about tactically, right, that might be a bit military is more getting people to follow their squad leaders, right? But apart from that, it's all out there. And that's what makes this game. But we try and do everything. We have weeks of, you know, if I go for a day and I'm on for a fair while, we'll do basically the armor push. We'll do the galaxy drops. We'll do death mode. Death mode is when we all press the AU button at once and drop on one base and that sort of stuff. and you know, we're constantly doing something new. We have competitions in the outfit. We, you know, if I jump on and you're running a squad, right, you're in the queue of taking out the Bastion, which can be worth anything up to 1,000 certs if you're any good at running it, you know, and that, so everybody gets a go. I don't take the Bastion out anymore. I've done it. I've got all the points I need, but all the new players that we try and build everybody's battle rank up, and that we give them vehicles. Us guys, like, we've got everything, like I have, we'll give a new player an ant that's already bombed out and all that, or a vehicle that they need to do something and whatever, and we do that sort of, we try and be helpful in that way, making sure that everybody's got everything. I constantly, it makes it quite easy. I've got constant squad boost and membership going, right? And also I've got on my ASP set to give me cheap vehicles. And I did that for a reason, so that I could pull more than one vehicle out. So I could actually basically equip my whole squad by myself. And that thing, especially when you put that advanced, like a galaxy for me is 225 nanites to pull a galaxy. That means I can pull two galaxies, and by the time I pull those two galaxies, my next lot of nanites are come in, and I could pull three galaxies by myself. So, you know, that's the ability that I try and do, which gives us a bit of an edge. And that, and Cowboy's in the same way, he can do the same thing. So does a few other players. But we look at all times to keep, it's taken a long time for us to get to where we are now. We've had a lot of problems with players coming in and disrupting and being disrespectful. The rules that we have in the game is a fair bit, and unfortunately the game, there's no way you can write it up but put it on the Discord or something like that, which we would be lucky if 25% of the players are on our Discord. I doubt there's not even that many. There's not a real lot, but people get there. I don't make it a compulsory that you have a microphone, but if you can hear, it'd be really good, and that's the thing. But everybody's welcome. We give everybody a shot, right? I'm a grumpy old bugger, right? I'm nearly 60, right? And Cowboy's a bit older than me. He's in his 70s. So.
Really?
No, I'm only lying. He didn't hear me.
I was waiting for more.
Yeah. TR, as a rule, are an older, mature empire. There's a lot more people around 35 plus playing TR, because it's hard mode. Anybody can play easy VS and easy NC, right? But it is hard mode being TR. So if you come over to TR, join our outfit, just remember this, it is hard mode, right? You've got a lot of things. They've nerfed everything about TR, they've nerfed down, you know? Of course, it's an ongoing job with Daybreak to make, because they know the better players go to TR. That's why they do this.
Well, it's also the devs play VS, so...
Yeah, true. It doesn't help.
Yeah, so that doesn't help.
But yeah. I'm just saying, at least the chain guns still go brrr.
Yeah, yeah. At least they sound pretty.
Yeah, that's it. I mean, I couldn't think of a more useless weapon than that damn chain gun. And they've just gave it a buff, right? And if they have given it a buff, I can't see where with it. I really can't. I mean, unless they make it so we can melee it and use it as a club. I can't see any use for it. But, you know, being in at the pigs, right, all my friends are on here, right, are on here and in pigs. It's simple as that. I've got some friends outside in the real world, but, you know, who cares about the real world? I mean, really, if you can sit down and do this and enjoy yourself. My kids, I made sure all my kids had top rate, like best computers, like they have it. Here's the thing. They never got in trouble with the police, right? They've never caused any trouble elsewhere.
They left that up to their father.
Well, that's it. Well, God, I might, you know, they took my young. I told you the story about my youngest boy. I started with a laptop about in 2011, 2010, around that time I bought a laptop. And that the kids had little, like, pissy things and were laptops and that. But I had this laptop. And I said, I asked Jackson to stick a game on there for me. And he did. And anyway, I know nothing about computers, you see, and I'm just like, it turn off, and things like that. And I'd walk away and there'd be no screen anymore. And I'd be constantly calling him out. Anyway, one day Jackson came out and he looked at me. He said, "Dad, your stupidity sickens me." And I thought from that day onwards, I will learn everything I can about computers. And I have. And that's why I'm into this game. That's why I play this game. This game is the only game there is. Unless
they still haven't found his kid either.
he's all right. He's all right. He got that 1080. Aura said 1080 graphic card. I gave.
Oh, did you give him that?
Yeah, like all their computers. Where do you think all this stuff goes?
Oh, that's right. You do the hand-me-downs.
Yeah, I don't sell it. Now, everything I've ever bought in computers, right, has always been handed down. So I've never got any money back from it. And that. The same with the monitors. I ended up with those one, the 22, 27 inch monitors, mm-hmm. right? The 1440 and the one 1080 and all that. My son, he got both those monitors. Jackson, the one that told me that my stupidity sickened him. He's got all those monitors. He's got all that setup. And that, so yeah. And he'll mostly end up with this setup eventually.
Yeah. That'll last a while though.
Yeah, so, I would love to see this game. They do some HD stuff, like do something with the weapons, all the weapons, and do something with all the vehicles. Do some HD work on them, make the vehicles look a bit more real. And they could do it with this engine. They could, because they've already proven that with some the guns, like the Jackal and all that. If you see the Jackal and see how refined that gun is, that if they can do that with guns, they can do that with vehicles. You know. And that sort of stuff. They could start doing things like that. And I'd like to see them do more of that because everybody's rigs can handle the game, but it's surpassing the quality. Like there's other games out there that have got better quality imaging and all that sort of stuff. But the thing, the downturn of that is like you play, I got Battlefield 1. I jump on there, but I can only talk to the four guys in the squad with me. I can't talk to anybody else and that sort of stuff. If they ever fix that up, right, it'd be a different kettle of fish too. I mean, the same as Call of Duty. They've got a different, a funny, weird comm system and that. None of them really got the comms. I mean, you think about it. We've got proximity chat. We've got outfit chat. We've got command chat. We've got platoon chat. We've got squad chat. We've got five different communications in the game. No game has that, except maybe Armor 3. You know, and I doubt they have that. All right. But yeah, that thing. I mean, this is what I. If this game stopped tomorrow, I have to be honest with you. I don't think I'd ever game again. I don't think I'd play another game unless, of course, something similar like this came out.
I think the appeal on it, it was mentioned earlier, is Enio mentioned it, is the number of people you can pack into a single battle.
True.
You can have a 100 versus 100 with different types of weapons. And it's not all guys with pop guns. You have armor, you have aircraft, you have a lot of people packed into a small area relatively. It's like an Omaha Beach type of event in respect to chaos. And other games cannot reproduce that with the small populations that you can't create that with 16 players.
The only other game that I can think of that just added this recently was Squad. I don't know if you heard of Squad, Kyle, but they recently added 100 versus 100 on one of their maps. But if I have to remember, yeah, but when it comes to Planet Side 2, though, you can have even more than 100 on not just two teams. You can have even more. So yeah.
And can I reiterate on something that Tiger said earlier about sophisticated plans and stuff like that?
Mm-hmm.
Well, some people try going for sophisticated plans, and more or less, Tiger just goes for the tactic of being able to keep everybody together in a tight cohesion and on point, essentially. And mm-hmm. as the old saying goes, the first casualty in war is the plan.
That's it. That's what the first thing that'll fall apart is the plan. And that's why I didn't have a plan, really. I didn't tell everybody. I said I had a plan, but I didn't have a plan for Outfit Wars.
Yeah, so it kind of evolved on the field because you don't even know what the map looks like.
It's about being adaptive as a commander, essentially, and a leader, if you will. in order to effectively get results.
So, one last question before we wrap up here. We kind of going over the time here, but I got time here. So, one last question here. And again, we don't have much information on this, so we're being a bit optimistic on this one. But last thing I want to ask you guys on Outfit Wars, I figured on bringing this up because you guys are very, very passionate on trying to be tactical whenever you can, but also being having fun at the same time. So, as you folks probably know, I don't know if you've heard this news already, but the devs have said vaguely that the next Outfit Wars is going to be, let's say, significantly different compared to the last two iterations that they've done so far. So again, we don't really know what it's going to be like, but they did say that the qualification phase is going to be less grindy and all that good stuff. So again, in brief terms, again, any of you can answer this one, but is the next version of Outfit Wars, regardless how it's going to be, they have yet to announce the new format there, but are you folks considering on participating in a new version of Outfit Wars in the future?
Yep, we most probably will. But here's the thing, when they started this game in 2012, the way they had it set up for playing and locking continents was the best way. Right, definitely the best way. It was never as good as that. But every time they seem to have a habit of making something good and then turning it into something bad, right? And which is sick. Now, the first Outfit Wars was perfect because it put every player on an equal. Then the other outfit, Recursion, complained about that. So the second Outfit Wars, you had to have, you got as much nanites as possible and things like that, and which they shouldn't have. I think that if the game, when we go on that battlefield for Outfit Wars, right, everything should be equal. Everybody should be equal like it was the first one. And that's the only thing I say, because every time they panter to one of these other outfits, they just make it easy for them to win. Recursion has been on all the last two, but they'll jump in like their NC accounts, their VS accounts. We beat them when they were NC. Right, but like they complained about the nanites and they didn't like it, and one little outfit like that complained, and the devs did something about it, you know, and that little change allowed them to beat everybody in Outfit Wars, and they've got to stop doing that, pandering to one outfit. They've got to cut it down. That's what I'm saying. With thing, as long as the next Outfit Wars is made more fairer, where an outfit like Recursion can't just come in like they did the second Outfit War, then wipe everybody. Like, because
My take on it is Outfit, they're throwing spaghetti at a wall, seeing what'll stick, trying to evolve the business model. They have a core player base, and as that ages out, there's attrition, there's static growth. They're looking at how to capitalize on the franchise and generate revenue. That's the bottom line. That's a business. And speaking of that, I have worked in the game industry off and on for decades, actually. There's a lot of titles I've worked on in the past. Number ones and some dogs. And so I understand the industry and the business. They are looking to expand the player base. And you look at the new questing, if you will, on Esomir. I fully support it and I absolutely hate it, because what they're doing is they're opening it up to trying to draw in a different player base, more of the adventure quest players. But I don't know if it'll succeed, because the game itself does not lend itself to that. They tried Planetside Arena. We just won't go there. Tiger and I played it. But the best thing that they've come up with is the Outfit Wars. We'll play it. I look forward to the rule changes. It's evolving. I'm glad they're evolving it. I support that effort. But again, you know, similar to what Tiger said, is call out that evolve it so it's balanced for everybody. Don't just listen to your buddies in one outfit that you run with. Where I worked in the industry in the past, if a dev ran with an outfit and did these things, they would be terminated because they are a risk to the business.
So Recursion had a couple of devs running with them, one with telling them the exploits. He got sacked. He actually, Drew has been sacked ages ago because of the retrenchment, right? But I was glad to see him go because he rolled with them, and like he didn't, what they seemed to be able to do all these things that no one else could do. And that's obviously information that was given to him by Drew, right, on PlanetSide. And, you know, that's wrong. No, you can't do that. You can't be a dev and run with an outfit and always run with an outfit.
Your team should be your business. Because at the end of the day, it's that balance that keeps the doors open.
I can remember there was a dude. Remember when PlanetSide used to stream? You could actually jump on PlanetSide and watch them streaming, and all the devs would be on there, and it'd be on 24/7. You jump on any time. There's constantly something on there streaming. And there was a dude, he's a sniper, and he showed where he was hiding and all that sort of stuff and that. But he wasn't in an outfit. That's the thing. He wasn't in an outfit. He was solo, and that's how it was. And how Drew ended up, he's still solo, but he ran with Recursion. All right. And that's the thing. That's where it all come unstuck, that sort of thing. And I think that did a lot of damage, and Recursion of the outfit does a lot of damage to the game because people start working out who they are, what has happened in the past, and everybody knows it's unfair, right? They may not aimbot and all that, but they do use exploits.
You got to figure there's folks there who have good skill and all that, and it diminishes the perception of them. I think because there are players on in Recursion and they walk over me, and I respect it in the game. Of course, an infiltrator is not going to do much against a heavy. And there are some really highly skilled players, and I think it's unfortunate that skill and capability is tarnished by those kinds of actions. I think it's unfortunate because there is great skill there and some good folks. And I think that kind of backroom dealing and leveraging things that shouldn't be leveraged, I think it tarnishes paints good things in a bad light.
And can I comment on that if you don't mind?
Yeah, go ahead. I mean, I've been letting you guys talk here, but I feel like these are very, very insightful conversations that I think deserve to be said. Would you agree? Go ahead, Akita.
Yeah.
Yeah. I was going to say that with hearing that, all right, hearing all that you just heard, just saying something to the audience is that if anyone to Daybreak is listening, there's better ways to handling this. You know, create a dev-only outfit such as like CCP. Host events on that dev-only outfit. So that way everyone knows that you're not favoring one specific group of players because you're buddy-buddy with them. No, everyone there is at the office and is a part of the office and a member of the office. And second of all, run with the rules as same as everyone else. There should not be two rules, one for me and one for anyone who's the dev's friend. You know what I mean? It should be even playing field across the board. And as such, it's frankly sickening to hear that there are devs who abuse their position.
Won't be the first time in a game. Won't be the last.
No. Yeah. I mean, I personally haven't heard of that, but I won't be surprised if there are some games out there that have this type of thing going on. And I just hope that I hope those things will not ruin the games that we love, especially this one in particular.
Yeah. I mean, like, let's say a company for like CCP, for example, who run EVE Online. If you abuse your position as a dev, you get fired the same day.
Which is the way it's supposed to be.
That's it.
Absolutely the way it's supposed to.
Here's the thing, though. The planet side made it obvious that Recursion's their pet when they changed the rules of outfit wars because they demanded it. You know what I mean? That was so blatant that, like, we all saw that. We all heard it on about Reddit. They complained about not having enough nanites and all that. But we were all in the same boat. Does it matter? You know? And they didn't like it. It really stuffed them around. The whole thing of them not having nanites really backfired on them. They went in there bragging that they were going to win. And when they came to the day, they got slaughtered. And they got slaughtered because they couldn't use exploits that they normally did. That's why they needed those extra nanites too to do other things. I don't know how they do it. See, people got gaming mats and they use bloody micros and stuff like that. All right. And of course, if you don't have the extra grenade or whatever or something like that, the sticky grenade as such, right, and you've run out, then that button that you had exploit ready to, you know, use, that's no use now. It's got not so supplies. That's what they didn't like. They couldn't continue. They started off all right, right? They actually started off all right, right, good. And then once all their nanites were gone, they were finished. They had no plan, right? With us, we constantly kept going, had our tactics with our squad within our squad tactics perfect with 4 medics, 3 engineers, 2 heavies, a light assault, and an infiltrator, and that sort of thing. We had that set up like that, and we had and that was before we had the canopies. There was canopies in that later on in the next one, but in this one we didn't have any canopies or anything like that that we could take and into it. But that's what I'm trying to say about it. It's where they let us down, is that they should never have touched the Alpha. I said that when I was interviewed when we won it. I said, don't touch outfit wars. Leave it the way it is for a while. Get everybody to get used to the way it is. But they didn't. They changed it straight away because Recursion was not happy. And this is most probably the underlying thing on this server, is that outfit. Now, it wouldn't surprise me if there was another outfit on Emerald that does the same thing and that another Deb plays on because he's in that area or whatever, you know. And that sort of stuff. And I'm sure this is going on every server. There's that one outfit that gets all the goodies. Recursion is our outfit.
So when it comes to the qualification phase, that is that something that you personally agree with the changes?
I'm not sure what the change will be.
Well, basically, I'm going to give you the lowdown. For the first one, you basically need to grind for points for, I think it was a week or two. It was a bit too long. No.
That was perfect. That was perfect. It went on for 3 weeks. Okay.
Recursion was ghost capping. They spent all their time ghost capping continents in order to get points. Remember that?
Yeah. But here's the thing. What it did was, because we all had to be on, because it was for 3 weeks, we all had to be on. Because any one of us could have been taken over. You know what I mean? Someone could have got ahead of us. So you forced everybody. There were 3 continents open at all times for those 3 weeks. People don't realize it was, and they went and changed it. They went and made it for 1 weekend. What rubbish. They had it. They had it made. They reinvented the whole game by the qualification. The qualification, right, took 3 weeks. It meant you had to play. We all had to be on. All right. And we did. And everybody did stay on. And I've never seen it. The last time it was that big was, I don't know, 2013 or whatever. The first time the game came out, you know, you had that many people. Like I said, it was 3 continents open. Sometimes the very first week, there were 4 continents open at once.
Well, anyway, to go back to the question there, I know we're running over in time here, but when it comes to the qualification phase, in short words, do you like the shorter qualification phase, about 6 or 8 hours, or do you prefer the old one?
3 weeks should be 3 weeks, and then you've got a week to get ready for the battle. So there's 1 week where there's no qualifications. It should go on a monthly thing, once a month. All right, 3 weeks qualification, then you've got a week to organize. And that's how it should be. If they did that, it means we all got to be on. Or we can't be in it. We can't do outfit wars. And that's what happened the first outfit wars. Everybody was on. But the moment they changed that thing, the weeks leading up to outfit wars, there was no one on.
Mm.
The second one. Yeah, they've got to go back. They really got to go back to the original making it 3 weeks. They need the forces to stay on to do it, to stay ahead.
And with that, I'm just trying to think. Just wanted to just a bit of a do a recap. So we basically saw you guys playing in action. Space Pigs, you guys are take coordination very seriously, the plans. And the thing, other things that stand out, what you just told me for the last hour or so, is you take very big passion on your win in the first outfit wars, or outfit wars in general. If you could say, other things I can really recall from the top of my head right now are, you're very open to new players, helping out new players whenever they're interested, and you basically have zero tolerance for any certain wrongdoings. Is that right?
Spot on.
Yeah. Yep.
And speaking of when it comes to this is the last thing I just thought of. When it comes to changes in the game, do you guys take that okay, or are you guys willing to adapt? Because I know you guys made it pretty clear that you have very, very strong opinions in this game, whether you agree or disagree on certain things. So when it comes to change, this will be the last one for sure. I'm not going to drag this any longer, but are you guys have no problem adapting to this game, how it's going to change for the future?
We do. We do adapt. And a lot of it is it may sound a wee bit corny, is that you want to support the product, and you want to support the company in some manner, because it is a good product. So we always adapt. It's just sometimes what we adapt to is really lousy until they change their mind 6 months later and undo it.
They don't talk to the players, right? They've gone ahead. They do.
I know, Pale. Sorry to interrupt, Pale. But are you willing to adapt as a group? Are you willing to adapt?
Oh, yeah, definitely. We've had to. We wouldn't be here now.
I know. We're kind of repeating the same things over and over again. But I just wanted to focus on the adapt situation. So Akira, I don't know, you're kind of busy there right now, but you would also do the same thing for new players and all that stuff.
Yep. Yeah, we continue going.
I asked Akito. Pale. Sorry, I asked Akito.
Oh, yeah. Sorry. Sorry.
Apologies. I couldn't hear the question over command chat. Could you repeat it real quick?
As you're out there as a group, I know this game has been changing so many times from one decision or another, especially after wars. But as a group, especially with the new players, are you guys willing to adapt and stay on for many days, months, years to come?
Well, of course. You know, we got to be able to stand there and be able to stand united in the game we all love to play, essentially. A community that we are building for ourselves in this outfit that we call Pigs, essentially. You know, we're all here. I personally consider it a bit of a pseudo family, if you will. Seeing everybody adapt and grow up and learn new tricks of the trade, shall we say, and then eventually just completely dominating and becoming that top tier player one day or another. And it all starts when we're all newbies, if you will. We were all scrubs at one point. I personally have been playing since the beta and on and off, more or less, and I've seen this game change drastically over the years. One time I came back, and I didn't even know this, but there was a drastic change to how nanites essentially work and function with the vehicles, and more. And I believe that's around the most recent vehicle update with the Colossus.
Yeah.
The Colossus and the Bastion and such. I never thought they would add something like that to the game, or a fourth faction, if you will, somewhat, you know, where they autofill for the least populated faction. But more or less, I am probably going to be here for a very long time, and I encourage everybody to hit up the pigs, oink, 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 if they want to be able to learn those new little tricks of the trade and find a friendly outfit to run with.
And I just remembered something, and again, this is related to you guys. Try to keep this answer short or brief if you can, but does Space Pigs have any interesting community events going on, whether it's in your Discord or in-game? I know you guys have ops, but do you guys have any other interesting community events going on in-game, such as, like, I spoke to other outfits, they have some silly community events, like, such as posting, vote on which sandwich looks the best. They actually post the photo on the Discord and they decide which is the best looking sandwich and all that stuff. So any silly events or anything like that you guys do within your Discord or your group?
Well, we've got, as you know, we've got competitions, right? As the Bastions, like who's doing squad leads and that. And we've got a $100 Steam card that's for the person that's, you know, the last few months have been doing the most platoon leading and that. It's very hard to get people to jump on and start a platoon if there's not one already going and that sort of stuff. But that's how we try and get it. We try to maneuver everything into starting a platoon, get on, start a platoon, start a squad, and that sort of stuff. We have done the what's the name quest, which was created by Rumble. We used to do the shitter comms. We meet in bases and we fight at certain areas and all that sort of stuff. And that we used to do that. Lately, like I said, there's been a constant changeover of players at all times. I mean, even though we've got 2,000 players, the fact of the matter is not all of them are on. And I mean, you know, that's the thing. But like, we've constantly got something different happening as we go along. Could we get? There's always say this. There's the good, the fair chance that the person I'm talking to today that's new to the outfit, I won't be speaking to in 6 months' time, because people play other games, and that sort of stuff. So yeah. We've got to keep constantly changing things up so that people come back.
Yeah, I don't know if we do anything silly or anything like that. For me, my work has exploded due to the pandemic because it's related to efforts in that. So for me, real life has taken over for the last several months. So I haven't really been keeping tabs on any of that myself.
Any plans to add some fun random community events, stuff like that, like I was mentioned, maybe post maybe vote which is the best sandwich or anything like that in particular? Any plans?
Well, we could have Tiger move into the winner's house for like two weeks.
Yeah, that's it. That'd be
I think that would be
I should come and live with you.
Oh god. I have a garden shed.
Well, I have
locked it from the outside.
I had a competition going saying that, you know, I'd give someone something if they could find me feeding my cats. All right, because I've got 25 cats.
So, really?
Yeah, they're all over the place, right? You know, they're up hanging from the fan and everything and that sort of stuff. And yeah.
Yeah, I remember that. You had a contest to find a picture of you. And people did manufacture some pictures.
They did. Yeah. There's a lot of memes. A lot of people have made memes of me and that. You've got it after this, when you get a chance, maybe tomorrow or whatever, just go Pale Tiger memes. Just do that. It's just you'll laugh. And that's mostly one of the biggest things that people do on here is make memes about me. But as for competition, that I suppose we could do some things, but it's more to do with, like, we put stuff up occasionally on our Discord or on our website. We've got a web. Actually, that's what I might do, is give you a link to our website so that you can put your stuff on.
Yeah, just giving you guys a bit of some ideas, just to bring some excitement to new players or people that like to use Discord a lot. Because I know there are players out there that like to use Discord a lot, and that's one of the things some of the players can be looking at. What does this group do? Do you have any events or community events everybody can come together to? So that sort of thing. But again, this is your group. Everybody.
I like the suggestion.
But like I said, don't take my word for it completely. If you don't want to do that,
I'll put you to work. It's your job.
Well, not only that.
Welcome aboard.
Well, not only that, Cowboy. The other thing I want to add was every outfit group out there has their own view, their creative point of view. So maybe they don't want to do that, but it's just a suggestion of mine. If that's something you guys like to do, because I can definitely see more interest on a group that likes to do community events after doing the last four episodes, including today, that I've been doing. Because everybody is different on how they want to keep things interesting within their group. So that's just something I wanted to bring up.
I've got to admit, after you interviewing us, I sort of always considered us a serious outfit, right? We do have a bit of fun, but I didn't. After this, I'm starting to think of all these other ideas that you just brought up. I realized that we've been very, very serious outfit for a long, long time. Maybe we should do some of these other things just to lighten things up.
Well, it's again, it's your group. It's you're in charge. I'm just spouting random ideas that I've noticed other groups have been doing. So
yeah,
again, you don't have to do it, but it's just what I thought might help you guys out.
Yeah, we.
It might present Tiger as a nicer person too.
Ha ha ha! I have been good.
You have been good for at least, what, 2 hours now?
Rubbish. I've been good for a few weeks. Right? I'm trying not to lose it.
So okay. The neighbors haven't called the cops on you in 2 weeks?
I'm in the front of the house. I've moved.
Really?
I'm in the front of the house.
Well, that's
now.
Right. You told me. Yeah, they let you out.
You know how many times I've walked into the other room and walked past my computer room now? I walk past it, go, and then I realize, no, I'm in the other room. And because that's, I've gone from the closet to the cat's room. I was in the cat's room originally and ended up in the closet. And that now I've got to the room that I always wanted, air conditioned, the works and everything. At the front yard, people can barely hear me out here because, we're fairly big street. So from the other house across the road is just about 50 meters. So they're not going to hear me screaming like a banshee. Like they did at the back. There used to be a lady that used to do swimming training for children, right? Until I moved into the back room. Yeah. And of course, you can imagine what came out. And my missus used to come into the room and say, there's little children out there and all that. And of course, I'd possibly be, because at that time I was drinking.
You're teaching them new words.
I know. But anyway, I didn't realize that that little business went broke.
Because kids came back.
No. Well, the thing, and I had a look the other day. The pool's full of rubbish, and that sort of thing. I think they even moved. Luckily, we own the house here, so sort of thing. I'm not a very good neighbor. I am not a very good neighbor.
Cowboy, if you stole one of Pale's cats, would he notice?
Yes.
I believe he would, because he spray paints numbers on them and he organizes them at night.
That's just my lousy attempt trying to make a joke there.
Yeah, but here's the thing. At night, when it's bedtime for me and my cats, I get into a big mother cat suit and lie on the ground and I feed all the other cats. They all come up to me.
Oh, you must be lying. You don't do that.
No, I do. I've got a big furry cat.
Oh, we're talking about furries now. Oh, God.
No. I just use it for feeding my cats. It's so that they keep calm and they feel relaxed, right? The furry costume just so happens to be a furry costume.
Never thought I would hear Pale talk about furries.
See? That's it.
Are you ever going to go and help put that furry costume on, Cowboy?
No. No, I'm pretty good.
Oh, that was really bad on my part. Sorry.
What do you think he should furry up at the dog and chase the cat?
Oh, jeez.
What's the deal between you two and furries?
I ain't into that, man. No furry here. That's his thing.
I don't know. Look, here's the thing, girl. You've got to understand that we've kept it pretty clean as we're talking to you and all that, so we can't go into the big discussions and that. But normally we have a lot of this conversation. Like, I feel that furries should be considered as a race of people, right? And that they should be given their own land and be able to breed.
So, before I wrap this up, Akita, are you listening to all this about furries?
Well, I accidentally said the joke or the punchline into platoon chat instead of Discord, but I was just going to say, we're called Warpigs for a reason.
That's it.
Are furries involved, Akito?
I don't know about that, but there's certainly some secret furries among us all, aren't there? I mean, you could be a secret furry, couldn't you?
Yeah, you seem very interested in the subject.
You seem very inquisitive about it. Look, are you sure you're not?
Listen.
He's looking for a furry clan, isn't he?
I'm watching. I'm looking at his Twitch, and I can see. But in the background, is that not half a head of a costume?
No. Huh?
Like behind near the fan, you've got half. Like, have you got a furry costume there?
No.
No, I'll see it. It's under
here. No, you mean that? You mean that one there?
No, it's to the left.
Oh no, it's a plant. It's just a plant. That's all.
Oh, all right.
It's one of those fake plants that you can get. It's just to make the background look a little nicer. So, with that being said, though, I think that wraps it up here. We had a lot of long conversation here, mostly from you, Cal and Pale, but I guess. It's something that you just wanted to get out of your chest out of all this time, right? I mean you're entitled to your own opinion there. I mean, I'm pretty sure not everybody's going to be agreeing with it, but I still wanted to give you guys have your say there, and especially on the record for days and years to come when they see this clip, and just have you guys talk about furries being serious and all that. It was a very interesting conversation, wouldn't you agree?
Yeah, definitely, definitely. I'd just like to say, too, that we've had offers from Ashy TV and other people.
Mm-hmm.
Shout out. I've always refused in the past. This is the first time that I've allowed anybody to interview the outfit or do what you've done.
Interesting.
Before. Yeah, nah.
interesting. I feel kind of honored in a way. I mean, if we wrap this up, hopefully we'll wrap this up soon, but What made you say yes to me this time, if you don't mind me asking live on stream here?
Don't get me wrong. Ashley is very professional. I got to know him later on and all that sort of stuff. But the fact that the way you came on and how you asked permission and all that sort of stuff and the way you did it, you weren't bombastic, right? You didn't jump on and say, oh, my bloody this and that, and I'm going to, you know, highlight and whatever. You've asked, do we want to do this, right? You've gone through your protocol of how you asked me to do this. I liked the way you did it, right? I thought it was friendly, I thought it was respectful, and that's why I said yes.
Thank you. I mean, I did the same thing for the other outfits, for example. And if you guys are watching right now, you can talk to me after this. You can sign up on my Discord right now, and we can talk further there if you guys wish to have your outfit on a being outfit showcase. Now, I'm going to tell you guys here and the audience right now, I've already had a couple of no's already from several outfits. I'm not going to name them just for pure respect, but I knew going in that I'm going to get either some outfits that are going to be interested, maybe lose it, or they said they were interested, but then they didn't say no over time, or just lose interest all that way. So what I'm trying to say is, I know that even if I do these episodes or trying to look for outfits that are going to be interested in the future, I know there's going to be some people that are going to like this and some people I'm not going to like. But things happen, and that's just how it goes, really. And I just try to be respectful as much as possible whenever I ask outfits to do something like this. And like you said yourself, Pale, I mean, I try to be, I guess you could say, diplomatic as much as possible. That's one of the reasons why I never talk politics or anything like that in my channel here, because again, no one wants to hear that after a long work day. Let's just be honest.
If I can just add something, man, you know, You're a cool guy. And so I'd like to say, if you ever want to roll with us and bring home the bacon, then go ahead.
That's it. Yep.
Here's the thing. You're always welcome aboard.
Yeah, that's it. But here's something else too. Because we are most probably the most known outfit on Connery, right? I am known on Emerald, but I'm not, the outfit isn't. All right. And that the only reason I'm known on Emerald is because of Raoul and that sort of stuff. And don't know how Raoul knows about me, but he does. But here's the thing. Hopefully, once we, this will break the ice for you on this server, because once, I mean, if the pigs went and did it, then, and the other people are refusing to take interviews from you and all that, then they're silly. Because if the pigs are willing to do this, then other outfits, I think, will want to do this too, because we've done it. You've come to the right outfit off the cuff, if you know what I mean, because we're so well known in that. So obviously, I think we'll stick your, once you've finished and everything up, it'll go on our website and it'll go on our Discord and that sort of stuff. And I'll most probably try and push it into the other outfit Discords and that sort of thing for you, so that people know. But once people see this, I think you're going to be all right. I think the people that said no to you before may not say no next time.
I hope so too. I mean, as you probably noticed when you watch the stream later, it's a bit rough around the edges, especially in the observer camp. Still getting used to that. But then again, you're not going to get better until you actually do it. You just have to take a risk and just be brave about it. That's all you can really do.
Right on.
If we do an outfit wars, and we do get in the next one, and depending how it is and what it is, right, we don't, there's no battle rank to join outfit wars with. You must do the training or whatever. Now, if you want to do the training with us when it's time we're in, and then you want to film it and actually go into an outfit war with us, you're quite welcome to.
Sure. Like I said, I'm not too sure when it's going to happen, because the last time they did outfit wars, they had it on weekends, and unfortunately, I work weekends, so it's a bit too late for me on that. But we'll just have to stay tuned and see what happens next.
Well, we are getting, I reckon, I heard a vicious rumor that what you said about the outfit was going to happen Christmas time.
I don't know.
We'll see what they do.
I'm just staying optimistic at this point.
Yeah, and if they do it, two things can happen. It'll either work with a game or crash.
Yeah, they'll do it Christmas morning, so all the little children are crying near the tree because they can't open the gifts because daddy's playing Planet Side.
Okay. But yeah. with that being said though, I'm gonna close out to the audience here. And again, I know that was a bit of a long talk at the very end there compared to what we did in the combat phase. It was very short. But I hope you guys had a good time. And if any outfits out there that wish to participate in the outfit showcase in the future, just get a hold of me on Discord and we could talk from there. And with that being said, actually, you know what, Pale, you want to quickly post on the chat what the Discord link is for your outfit? I don't think we have posted that yet.
All right, just a sec.
Yeah. So there's the official website for Space Pigs. That's their outfit name, and that's their official website. And while Pale is gonna get the Discord link out for you guys to check that out, I just wanted to say thank you so much for watching me here. I mean, I know I didn't get a lot of people chatting on live chat here tonight, but that's okay. The main thing here is, as long as I've entertained you in one way or another, I've done my job, and I feel very happy of that. And with that being said, once Pale gets the Discord link out, we will be wrapping this up here. So is there anything else you guys want to say while Pale is working on that Discord link?
I just want to say thank you for having us on, and I wish you the best in this whole endeavor.
I know. Thank you, Kobe. And
a lot of work. That's a lot of work. And I hope, you know, like you said, and you're willing to learn along the way, and that's the main thing.
That's what I'm hoping for, yeah. And there's one other thing while Pale is getting the Discord link up, posted in chat. If anybody out there likes to play Among Us, I'm hosting Among Us every Saturday at 11 p.m. Eastern. That would be about 1 hour and 50 minutes ago. That's when I usually started. So again, if you want to bring your friends along or you bring your outfit mates along for a game of Among Us, you can come on board to my Discord server here at any time, and we'll be doing the same thing here in voice chat with Among Us. So if that's something you guys like to do, feel free to come here and we can sign you up for that. So that includes you guys too and your outfit mates. So if you guys like to do that, it's completely optional to you, but just want to let you know about that if you guys like to do that.
Cool.
And what?
Oh, I was just gonna say I got drop off shortly here.
No worries. I just wanted to give out the closing statements here. And there you go. Pale's finally got the Discord link there. So check that out if you guys wanna consider joining Space Pigs in the future. And with that being said though, we are finally gonna say goodbye to the audience here. So again, stay safe, everybody. I'll see y'all next time. Take care.
All right, see you later.